It wouldn't be a typical motherfucking Etika stream if the motherfucking mic wasn't muted. What's going on, guys? I don't worry. That wasn't actually a troll. That was a genuine stream fuck up. All right. Well, that went completely sour. I meant to motherfucking do something cute with the Valentine's Day Joy-Con, nigga. But clearly my plan didn't work out. Oh, the fuck well. Anyways, guys, how the fuck have y'all been? What I was saying before I was reminded about the mic is that we missed a lot of holidays. So Valentine's Day. Y'all niggas got me. I'll just leave this here. That's my only decoration. And funnily enough, it's on the goddamn bed. You know, the Joy-Con technically can be used as vibrators if you get the dock and you use the Find My Joy-Con feature. These motherfuckers shake real hard, bro. I'm telling you, you can use that for extracurricular type activities, if you understand what I'm saying. Niggas are inside of the chat, though. I appreciate y'all being patient with me while I tried to change up my whole shit. You can look at my nuts now, nigga. You can look at my nuts in all their glory, my boy. Take a fucking look, my boy. This is the goal. I've achieved it. Yes. Now I can spread eagle for the whole fucking world to see. I'm out here, Brooklyn, New York, man. I'm chilling. The boys are in the fucking chat. I missed y'all niggas. I don't give a fuck what any Reddit says. I don't give a fuck what no negative naysayers say, man. Let these niggas talk as much bullshit as they want to on some real shit. I missed y'all niggas. And I am so fucking excited. Words can't even express the things that I feel, bro, the stuff that I'm looking forward to. I'm just glad to be back in the mix, baby. I missed y'all niggas, man. I see you guys in the chat, man. I see so much love. I feel the passion, the energy. I clearly niggas a motherfucking miss me. So thank y'all for welcoming me. The only thing that's weird about it is why the fuck are we on Twitch? Well, I don't know. I kind of wanted to do a little bit of like a, well, I kind of planned on making like a, big return sort of stream, but nigga, who gives a flying fuck, man? We back and we're on Twitch. I'm gonna show my dick here, get banned, and I'm gonna go off to YouTube. they'll probably believe me when I say that shit too. I got a bottle of water. Let me see in the chat, what are you niggas' estimates on how fast I'm gonna get banned off this bitch? Last time it was pretty damn quick. These niggas at Twitch aren't slacking. They took my channel down literally the second after that live stream ended. You remember that shit? When was that? What day? Oh yeah, that was the stream when I came back after the whole mental breakdown shit, right? Oh yeah, so yeah, Twitch. Let's see. Maybe these niggas will break a record. Maybe they'll ban me in the middle of the stream. Hey, listen, just don't say the N-word in the chat and we'll be good, okay? 1 hour? An hour? That's a long ass time. You think you're gonna wait an hour, nigga? I don't know, bro. That's a big guesstimate, my boy. Bro, what have we missed? Nigga, please, in the chat, you gotta help me out. I already have a couple of things written down, but we've missed so many events, so much internet bullshit that's happened over the last month, man. And the thing that makes it crazy is the fact that, like, I didn't really stream, so I couldn't talk about it in the way that I wanted to. Getting the point across through Twitter, like, tweets and shit like that, Instagram stories, you don't really get the full effect of talking to niggas in real life, you know what I mean? Oh, yeah, he said it already? I could say nigga! I'm black! I have an N-word pass! It's a permanent pass, man! I'm good! But, I mean, you know, I guess I'm gonna get banned from Twitch. But nah, Twitch ain't getting banned from me! Twitch? Wait, no, excuse me. I'm not getting banned from Twitch. Twitch is getting banned from me. That was what I was trying to say. But wave check, nigga? Hold on a second. Don't bring it up. Yo, the wave check, the memes, bro. Oh, so many memes. I felt so empty, niggas. I'm so glad to be back in the mix of the bullshit, bro. And of course, if you're talking about mixing up bullshit, you gotta motherfucking hold on a second. Wait a minute. It's been a while since we've had motherfucking donations on. Niggas is out here, bro. Thank you, man. Yo, big thanks to whoever the fuck that is. Oh, wait, when I stand up, you can't even fucking see me. Maybe I'll change the fucking angle later on. Haskell the Rascal is back at it, man. Yo, my boy is in here. You're the first one to come back. 2019, man. First donation. Haskell, my nigga. Screenshot this moment and save it in your phone or something like that, my boy. Although it probably won't mean much. I mean, considering if I'm like gonna be doing YouTube for years and years, I mean, nigga, there'll be plenty of times of people getting first time in the years to come. But hey, he says, I'm glad to see you back, my boy. I'm glad to be back in here, man. We're not gonna be doing Twitch consistently, by the way, just to let you guys know, it's just like for trolling. I'm just here to troll at the moment. We're gonna be doing some bullshit later on today, so I mean, if you guys are ready to motherfucking have a good time, then let me see a one in the chat, you know? I didn't even get a chance to look at the chat, man. Haskell, thank you once again, bro. He says, now let's see that fat meaty cock, my nigga. Has, man, you can't, it's not that easy, bro. I don't care if it's a new year and a new place, seemingly so. Bro, on Twitch especially, like, dogs, I think if I try to do that on Twitch, not only will my channel get banned, anybody that I know will get banned on this bitch. They try to do that apparently to this nigga named Monkey Jones. I know some of y'all have heard of him. He's like this controversial dude who's like talking about these crazy, well, it's not really like, he's controversial because he talks about dark humor and shit. It's a whole thing, though. It's a whole song and dance. I don't know if y'all makers want to get into that, man. But, bro, thank you so much once again, Haskell. I appreciate the fucking love. All the boys out here who stuck with me, who were riding with me, who knew what the deal was, man. Y'all are some real ones. Trust me, I got y'all, motherfucker. Everybody, man. I'm glad. I'm so happy, bro. Already, of course, I'm seeing a bunch of fucking suggestions from the boys, man. Don't worry, bro. We got plenty of time here. I wanted to spend a lot of time with y'all. The Broly. Did y'all see the Broly movie? That shit was fucking crazy, boy. I mean, there's so much to talk about, boy. Hold on a second. Let me actually see what the fuck my deal is. It's been a long time, bro. I'm almost a little bit nervous, man. If you see my heart rate's currently at 96, boy. This is like so out of the norm for me. The last stream was in December, bro. And I went all of January. I didn't stream. February, I didn't stream for like almost half the month, right? So, I mean, basically, as you guys can see, I moved. I finally got a new place, man. So, yes, I mean, I didn't want to spend too much time talking about it. And I know I went a long time without telling motherfuckers what the deal was, but, oh, Soulja Boy 2. That's a whole nother meme all on its own, man. The Soulja Boy meme almost sort of ties in with the AirPods meme in a sense, because it's kind of like flexing in a way, the Gucci headband and all that shit. But, yo, yes, thank you so much to Bloodspark, who just said congratulations in the chat, man. Everybody was saying congratulations. Thank you, Volu, Xeon, I'm seeing a bunch of these Ihego faces in here, as turned on as I get by that. I prefer not to see in the chat, but then again, you know, I don't mind walking around the stream with a boner. I mean, I was going to do so anyways. hold on a second. We have a bunch of motherfuckers in here, man. Cosmic Rays, Red Bundy. God, I feel so awkward. This is so weird. It's like, holy shit, back in the stream schedule, man. I'm here, man. I'm here, boys. It's been so long. There's so much to talk about. Where do we even begin? So, all right, I'm going to give you guys like a chronological timeline of exactly how things went down. Maybe it'll be a little bit messy, but right after that Christmas stream, a lot of things changed. Dogs, I had saved up a lot of money. I just saved up enough, and I was like, okay, I'm going to try to go for a place. Went for places, looked around, finally got one. So we're good. And thankfully, this place has everything your boy needs, so we are good. Boy, oh boy, all of 2018 I spent working on this shit, you know what I mean? And, you know, I think this is definitely necessary. I think I'm going to definitely let my heart out a little bit here. It was hard, bro. Like, I know a lot of you guys have probably been through some kind of fucking hard shit in your lives at this point. And I feel like this was one of the hardest challenges that I ever had. Because it was difficult considering that I had to sort of limit what I was doing in a way, with my productivity, since, you know, I was living with mommy. I had to make sure she was good. I didn't want to go too wild or too off the wall. So thank you so much to Bob Schmurter for your subscription. Somebody else had subscribed too earlier. I just don't know where those are going right now. I still got to figure it out. But anyways, it was just kind of difficult, man. And even though I wasn't able to be there fully, I really just wanted you guys to know that, bro, my heart is still in it. Some people, some bitch niggas going around telling motherfuckers out here that I don't care about YouTube anymore. Niggas out here thinking that I quit and shit. Bro, niggas are never gonna, bro, I've been doing this YouTube shit since 2006. Bro, my heart is in it. If I ever did lose passion for it, trust me, you guys would know ASAP. But it's kind of like challenges with the shit, you know what I mean? But I don't want to dwell too much in the negative, because the positive is that now a nigga is finally here with his boys. We got this whole new YouTube channel. Bro, if we open up motherfucking YouTube, how many subscribers does this new channel have that I fucking made, man? Oh, hold on. Girl gets a huge Nintendo tattoo. You know, that's my homegirl's son right there. I didn't get a chance to see that yet. I'm gonna save that on the side. Oh, look at that. You see in the fucking, as soon as you open up my gut. Wait, hold on. How am I suggesting? Looking right now, what is there any sort of fucked up things that you can guess I watched recently just looking at my fucking YouTube page right now? Well, I mean, you can obviously guess what this one is from. This nigga, I watched one of his videos earlier, and the intro had me dying. I mean, the rest of the video, it wasn't, like, all that interesting. Not to be mean to the guy. He was just showing you how to get good waves. But, bro, there was this one video that he had. Hopefully, I don't have any fetish material in my YouTube history right now. How is Kobe, by the way? Wait a minute. What do you know about Kobe? I don't know about Kobe. I mean, hey, it's... Did y'all hear somebody else here earlier? It's just me. I'm the only person in here. Wait a minute. I don't see nobody. Yeah, that's it, bro. I don't know. Maybe it was a ghost or something, my nigga. What the fuck does that... Wait, hold on. What'd you say? What the fuck does that mean? Yo, Silver Absol is in here, bro. What's going on, Silver? Been so long, man. Maroon Macro says, thank you for the place. Bitch, why you lying? I'm not lying about nothing, man. Maybe later on something will happen. But for now, I'm just trying to figure out where that fucking video was that this nigga... Okay, here we go. I found it. Look at this intro, man. This shit killed me, bro. It's...
What's up? It's your boy, 360.
Hold on a second. Let me just fast forward a little bit.
And today in this video, I'm going to teach you guys
how to get the waves.
Deep waves, all right? So stay tuned.
Hold on. Did he sing that himself? This intro is so funny, bro. I mean, why the fuck? This 6 digits. Like, bro. I gotta love the fucking... You edited this shit all together yourself, huh, bro? I respect it. The glitch effects are cool, but it's just like... And it's not like it's corny, but it's just like, what the fuck? Like, nigga, this shit is funny as hell, man. I don't know. That's why I was watching that one. Just to explain my... YouTube recommended. I don't want to go too much into it, man. You see, this shit fact it has me hype already. It's currently, as you guys can see, 10:13 p.m. We are going to be chilling, my boys. Oh, who else is in there? Yo, Joshua? Is that you, my boy? Is that Joshua JJG? Hold on a second. Bro, I can barely even go. The chat is crazy, man. I forgot what you Twitch niggas is like over here. I'm seeing Sans in this bitch right now. The beeps? Oh yeah, the beeps are coming from the heart monitor, so that probably is an indicator that I'm going to die. Also, if you guys have anything interesting that you want to say to me throughout the duration of the stream, you can definitely go ahead and check out my Twitter page, man. We're going to be, wait a minute. Never seen someone break Twitch TOS faster than Etico. Well, how did I break the fucking TOS? We're not banned yet, are we? Are we good? Refreshing this shit. We're out here. I'm not breaking any rules, are we? Nah, we good, man. Damn, 8,000 viewers. Yo, respect to y'all, niggas. Thank y'all for coming through. Shit, I didn't expect nobody. I'm surprised that y'all still... How come so many of y'all are still following this Twitch page? You know damn well I ain't gonna do nothing on here anymore. Y'all be holding on for any sliver of hope potentially possible, bro. Aura's in here too, bro. Wait a second. Everybody's in the chat right now. All the homies. Turn off slow mode, nigga. Wait a second. I didn't even realize this shit was on slow mode. That's not a good sign. Nigga, that means this shit go off of slow mode. I ain't even gonna see. It's probably gonna crash the whole goddamn chat again, man. We can't do that again. But like I was saying, even though I know the stream minimum donation is really, really high right now. So, but you know, it was the return stream. I had to come back and make sure I could spend time in here with my niggas. You know what I mean? But I mean, still, you can definitely go over to my Twitter page, which is very, very popping, by the way. If you take a look at some of the stuff I've retweeted, listen, some of y'all niggas might need a picture like this in your lives, bro, because guess what? It's fucking Valentine's Day. Very, very, as a matter of fact, it's Valentine's Day in 3 days, my boys. Hold on. If y'all have not been getting to the business yet, then you're slacking. I need to come in here and motherfucking teach y'all how to go for the gold, okay? Love me, have my kids. I am into that cuck shit to a certain degree, depending on how I feel when I wake up. But I'm not trying to cut niggas' wives out here, but I'll show you how to get a wife, all right? Maybe we'll do some Valentine's Day special or something. Imagine going out into the streets, bro. Into those streets and trying to fucking finesse Valentine's Day skills. I mean, it sounds kind of like a... Isn't that like sort of what those prank channels did back in the day? It's kind of seen as like an asshole thing at this point, right? As a matter of fact, hold on a second. I feel like one of those prank channels might be doing something at right now. I mean, let me see here. Chris from Prank Invasion? I don't know. It sounds like this would be the perfect time period for one of those channels to go off. Etika, what happened? Bro, every time I look at the chat while I'm trying to fucking how to get deep waves. All right, I was looking it up. I'm not trying to cut the flat top off. Like, I was looking it up just curiously because one of my... friends, he wanted to know how to get deep waves, so I wanted to find out for him. That's it. There's definitely nobody here that has deep waves currently staying in my house. He was a friend of mine from the back old days of YouTube. You know what I'm saying? And I was trying to check out what the channel was looking like. I hadn't really gotten a chance to look. To be honest with you, ever since October, when the whole crazy thing happened, I hadn't really looked too much at YouTube in general. I just kind of took like a little bit of a break from it, to be honest with you. But I mean, it was sort of needed in a way. But not even in time. Hold on a second. That shit is loud. Let's fucking go. Holy shit. Selenial PKB came into the stream with a $50 donation. Selenial, thank you. Thank you so much for your fucking love, man. He's saying, you're breaking my back, man. But I guess it's worth it to see the return of the Iceman. Crank out a beat for me real quick. Hey, listen. Listen. Yo, the Iceman. I took a break. My niggas was crying. They cried a lake. But I'm back. See the money I take. I'm coming through, cleaning up shit like a rake. Listen, I got the bread, nigga. See when I bake? Little bake oven. My nigga, I'm great. Hold on a second. I'm eating dinner. Go and get me a plate. I took that baby girl's titties and I put them on my face, nigga. Oh, that boy's trying to get back at it. Listen. Oh, man. Yo, hold on a second. I'm surprising myself right now. I'm feeling good, man. Yo, words can't describe how I've been, man. Like, it's just a certain level of freedom in having your own place. A lot of y'all motherfuckers out there are, I don't know, maybe some of you guys would be my age or whatever, man. It's a feeling, to be honest with you, man. Like, going through all that stuff and just coming back and being like, yo, I made it, man. I made it. I pushed through. I survived. I'm glad. I was talking a lot of stuff on Twitter, too, before I fucking did this stream, man. I know some of y'all niggas must have been like, damn, when this nigga coming back? But thankfully, niggas took it. Thankfully, niggas were patient with me, you know what I mean? Bro, look at this shit. 172,000 subscribers. And we have no content. But that's not going to be the case for too much longer. Today actually marks 1 month since I moved. It was back in, January 10th that I moved. And everything leading up to that was crazy because I had also gone to the dentist. And by the way, I don't know if some of you guys saw my post, but bro, take care of your teeth from earlier. I'm jumping back and forth from topics and shit like that. I know. I'm just literally just letting out my fucking thoughts, man. Like, I'm so fucking, I'm nervous in a way, you know? Like, to be honest with you, I think it's like sort of a normal human thing because it's like I've been so long away from streaming, bro, from making content. And now to be back into it, bro, it's like the possibilities are endless. As you can see with the new setup and shit, bro, like I got screens here and there, bro. Like I've done so much. I've done so much, man. I mean, I can move the camera around. Hold on a second. Take a look at this. I just want to share with y'all I guess I can't move it too much, but I mean, hey, it's a potential option, you know what I mean? Fuck Luke Bomber just subscribed. Okay. The nigga's name is Fuck Luke Bomber. Where's the t-shirt story at? Ah, shit. Okay. That one. Okay. To be honest with you, I'll probably be able to tell the t-shirt story if anybody still remembers that, by the way. One of these old ass motherfuckers, man. Oh, Smash 2! Hold on a second. I forgot! Me being gone for so long, bro, my channel, I didn't even get to do anything for Smash. Bro, hold on a second. I got so much stuff planned, bro. I remember showing you guys my to-do list before, man. It's crazy now. I got things planned. As you can see, I can barely fucking get concentrated on one thought. I've just been pulled in so many directions lately, man. You know what I'm saying? Ice Poseidon. Hold on a second. That nigga Ice is streaming right now, I think. He recently got a house, too. And the nigga actually reached out to your boy. Hold on, bro. There's so many things, nigga. If I scroll down my Twitter timeline, I can guess, like, get some of an idea of the stuff that I missed out on. Like, look, take a look at this. When Soulja Boy, you guys remember when he was selling consoles, he stopped selling consoles, the Breakfast Club thing happened. Bro, so many fucking things. Play Ridley on stream. Oh, yeah, that's another thing. I'm playing Ridley as a main now. That's going to be, number one, my best character. And he is kind of sick, too. But I've been testing my skill. I went to, like, some locals in New York, man. Bruh, I'm back. Yes, nigga, I'm back. Emperor Matrix, thank you for coming through, man. Price Will says he ran out of money. Oh, fucking course. Does Etico always stream on Twitch? No, I do not, man. This is like a rare instance. Let's see what my Twitter is looking like right now. Hold on. Yo, my nigga Etika's stream's reminding me of just how much I missed and loved this nigga. That rap was fire, though. We need more songs, bro. I was trying to get a better mic. Another thing relating to songs, I missed the Smash cypher. I was supposed to be on there. Someone says, yo, Etika, I saw you playing with Kobe earlier. Kobe actually had fucked up, man. On Instagram, that nigga on my last pick, which, by the way, always like a shameless plug, I plug the Instagram, and potentially. No, I'm kidding. But I mean, on the IG, this nigga Kobe had actually posted underneath one of my pictures and was like, yo, man, Etika's getting the business, bro. And it was like, wait a minute, you're not supposed to tell niggas that, Kobe. So some people figured it out early on, but it was all good. It was really, really cool to see my niggas again, man. Fucking Sully and Mo came through. Munching Orange and Sully. I mean, if you guys are fuck with the old school. Wait, are we banned already? We banned already, boys? Actually banned. FBI, open up. Really? Hold on a second. Are y'all trolling me or is this actually a real thing? Let me refresh. No, we're good. Okay. Thank you. No, we're good. I didn't do anything crazy yet. I think I actually do know the reason why I was banned from that last stream, but they never really clarified anything with me. CND. I just saw somebody in the chat say something about CND. Let me see if I can find that comment. Well, In regards to Alex right now, I know he's not in town currently. He's hanging out with like his family and stuff. Another donation coming through here. Tainted Krill came through with $50. Tainted, I remember you, man. What the fuck is good? He says, Etika, my boy, we are here together. I am here with you. Thank you, man. He sent me a link to a Twitter post, too. I appreciate you, bro. This song is so fucking sentimental, too. So the fact that a donation came on just kind of put me in my feels in a way. But Krill, thank you, man. What is this? I got a test Friday, but oh well. Was it?
I'm fucking ready for you, man.
Nigga, really? It's like, wait, hold on. What are you drinking? You drinking that water, bro? All right, I don't know, man. That isn't going to necessarily get you turned.
Fucking ready for you.
I'll be real. As of late, I've been doing a lot more weed than liquor. Bro, I mean, it's like, it's a sort of like a different thing in a way. I haven't really done weed my whole life, so doing that is kind of like interesting. Anyway, Chaos Jet, Chaos X Jet with $111. Thank you, man. Okay, it's starting to hit now, the fact that niggas are donating crazy amounts. That minimum is there for a reason. Chaos, thank you. I didn't even get a chance to read Krill's yet completely. Wait, no, I did actually. It's actually his fucking message here. I'm not taking a shot for that. You know what? I've been taking shots of that substance in your hand the whole fucking stream. So technically speaking, this is a celebratory one right here, my boy. Thank you, man. I appreciate the love once again. N-word banned. Nah, man. I can say the N-I-G-G-A. We're good. We're good. I'm saying the A-word, not the hard R. Chaos. Thank you. He's saying sponsors are mad. Please, I'm not asking for you to suck anyone's dick, but at least tell them something. The sponsor Discord chat is kind of toxic since they lost the sponsor chat. Other than that, much love to you. Are you talking in regards to like people still having their sponsorships for the old channel that was deleted? Because I thought YouTube refunded everybody for that shit, but if that's not what you're talking about, and you're talking about just in general, people not having like updates or whatever from like the sponsorship. More donations, nigga, fuck! We're out. We're fucking out here. Askel again with a $69.69 donation saying, my girl is on deployment and I'm actually proposing when she comes back. So give us some Valentine's Day tips by showing off how you fuck these bitches so I can use some. Well, to be honest with you, man, Haskell. All right, I'm going to share with y'all something. All right, I'm going to share with y'all something. You know, we're being real. FRFX, man. I'm not really too much of a playboy. My body list is really, really low. Although I have like interacted with a lot of girls, you know, I mean, I've kissed a couple girls, you know, I've touched a couple things, but I don't really have like a, I can teach you how to be smooth, but I can't tell you how to pipe it down. That's all on you. I feel like everybody has like an innate ability to have an attraction about themselves that they can portray to other people. That's all it is. But I'm not going to go into that, man. We clearly already have a bunch of stuff on top of us. Etika's flat top looking better than ever. Thank you, my boy. You know your boy's trying some self-love out here. That's important too, man. I mean, Valentine's Day, you got to love yourself too, of course. Like that's such an important category of being attractive. Being into yourself in a way, not really in like an egotistical way, but like taking care of yourself, showering for instance. That's a great fucking technique to potentially attract women to you guys. So if you don't shower at least once a day or something, then maybe that might help. I'm not trying to say y'all don't shower. I'm just saying for some people that's like a basic and they don't fucking comprehend that. You know what I mean? Etika, turn off slow mode again. No, never. I'm never releasing it. Wait, first off, how do I even turn it off if I really wanted to turn it off? Could somebody tell me? Nintendo Direct rumor. Oh, I forgot about that shit, man. Niggas are talking about that on Twitter a lot. But they were apparently supposed to be a direct earlier in January, right? Niggas were fiending for it, bro. Niggas was fiending almost as hard as they were fiending for a stream to come back, bro. The Avengers, bro. Did we wait? We watched Endgame together, of course, right? Will Kobe upload on this channel, bro? Kobe, we'll wait on that. I don't want to say anything else on it. Etika, stop with the whole fake. What was that comment? Hold on a second, bro. This chat is nuts, nigga. This shit is nuts, nigga. You a virgin? Oh no, don't call me out. Shit. I don't want people to know that much. I was trying to make it look smooth, man. Chaos Jet, thank you, bro. It's let me see here. I'm gonna refresh my notifications and see. Etika's one of the few people that I really admire. Thank you, bro. Let me whoa, hold on a second. Let me move my shit around real quick. I was watching a couple of videos earlier. I gotta clear my shit up. Oh yeah, I have Suns there already. Free Metroid Prime 4, bro. They delayed that shit, right? You see, I know a little bit about what's going on. Not everything, but I kind of got a little bit caught up. Look at your subreddit. Bro, I looked, nigga. These niggas apparently changed the subreddit up, man. Every single time I look at the chat, there's a whole new topic. But yes, apparently now... Oh, yeah, this is something really, really funny. I have to share this with you guys because it just goes to show you where the creativity of the motherfucking viewership is, man. Even though it was kind of like for crazy purposes, while I was setting things up, niggas got impatient. So instead of the Reddit page that I made a while ago still being based on me, they turned around and based that shit on another YouTuber, which is apparently Scott the Waz. So everything here is now based on him. Of course, I always come to the subreddit. Niggas, they think I don't come to the subreddit. I mean, there's always usually like some kind of wildfire going on here. This is like where you want to go if you want to see the most wild, like out of control animalistic side of the viewership, man. They're all my boys. You know, I care about them, but still, this is like a fucking, this is like a war zone right here. But it's pretty funny when the memes do come out naturally. And Scott the Waz is a pretty damn good YouTuber. I mean, he does like Nintendo shit and all that, you know? Luke McGrath Fett, thank you for coming through to the stream, man. And the subscription, even though I have no idea where that is actually going. This fucking nerd. Bro, I know. Let me see here. He looked like he was a cool enough YouTuber. Let me see. Maybe he's got something that the Joy-Con boys can gain something off of. Okay. So I never actually did watch one of his videos, but I subscribed and I followed him on Twitter and the guy did follow me back. So he seems like a cool guy. Why did the Reddit page choose to replace me with him though? Other than like, you know, the fact that he streams consistently, you know what I mean? Oh, Etika, the new Attack on Titan trailer. Hold on a second. Bruh. Get buff, nigga, let's go. Wow, fuck you, my nigga. Godly Mango with a... Nigga! Golly Mango, thank you so much for your donation, bro. $120 fucking dollars. I'm glad to see that you're back in a healthy and new place, my nigga. We're back on our bullshit, too. Thank you, man. I mean, dogs, I screenshotted so many warm and supportful messages from niggas while I was taking the time to, like, get my new setup set up and all that stuff. So, I mean... stuff like that, man, it really does put me in a good place. So I appreciate you with all that, man. It the love is real. I never didn't feel the love, but it's like sometimes niggas would be mean, man. While I'm trying to set up, niggas be hurting my feelings, but it's okay. I mean, I understand people get upset when they don't get what they want when they want it, you know what I mean? But thankfully I'm able to give what I want to give at the rate I want to give it now. So it's thanks to definitely niggas like y'all who are in the chat supporting your boy, who have been supporting your boy, and thanks to niggas like these niggas in the fucking donation box deciding to donate half of their fucking paychecks to me in one fell swoop. $120, $69, and $111 from Chaos Jet, even though his message was a little bit on the mean side. And Tainted Krill with that fucking water shot. Thank you to everybody who donated there. Stream chat, is the N-word really allowed in this stream? Well, there's no Nightbot, which is apparently like the big bad stream modifier on Twitch and YouTube gaming. And speaking of which, YouTube gaming is apparently going down too. That's kind of sad in a way. So like when you go to the fucking page, apparently this app is like, this website is no longer going to be used. It says gaming has a new home. Our gaming app is going away soon. YouTube gaming is where I usually stream. We're just on Twitch right now because it's like, fuck it. Nightbot is dead? Really? What happened to Nightbot? Bro, is discontinued or something? God damn. No. We're not switching to Twitch, all right, boys? Like, we're not going to become one of these niggas. Speaking of which, who's streaming right now? Oh, Tyler One. I've heard a lot about this guy. This is the League of Legends dude. I
I saw a lot of his memes online, and I would watch him more. It's just he's playing League all the time, and I'm not really too crazy about League. Twitch also has, how do I say this dude's name? XQCOW? XCO? Is that how I say it? But I've seen a lot of memes about this guy online, too. He's pretty funny. I remember he was trying to move that fucking, his face cam to cover the titties that were in his stream, too. Nah, Nightbot is fine. Oh, okay. XQC. How do I say it? XQC. Is that it? Let me make sure. Yeah, XQC. I said it correctly. Another donation coming through from Kingston Thrill, bro. Thank you, man. How was that water shot? I'll do another one just for you. He says, yo, but for real, man, my bro lives in Brooklyn, and I go there all the time. I'm trying to get lit with you, my boy. Oh, for real? It could also be you're trying to fucking murder me and put my guts all over the fucking pavement. But I mean, I guess I'll take the risk and hang with you, bro. Fucking, you seem like you know how to get it in. I'm off. No bullshit, though. Etika loves water is the hashtag, apparently.
I'm actually going to drink this bitch, bro.
You're actually going to drink it, nigga?
That last one, really? Used to fuck with you,
but... Really? It's real? That's not water, bro. Mm. That's not water.
Fuck with that. Fuck with that.
You said fuck with that? Okay, so now it's sounding like...
You don't fuck with that, do you?
So now you're testing my gangster out here, bro. Listen, Krill, I don't care if you donate $100. I don't care if you donate no dollars, nigga. Like, when you come on here and you test me, bro, that's when... I got something for you later, man. I'm going to build my mental I'm going to build my mental fortitude, bolster my defenses, and then take a shot for your ass later, okay, bro? I normally would do, like, celebration ones, but right now, I'm just in chill mode. I didn't want to get too crazy, guys. I wanted my first return stream to be more on a chill perspective. I just wanted to talk to my niggas again, you know what I mean? Etika, that was just a sip. He's probably a bitch. Yeah, I know, right? The only thing you're doing, man, is slightly getting a little bit, like, excited with that. You're not in party mode. You're not turned up. You're not drunk. You're not shit-faced yet, nigga. Stop acting crazy. I'm getting at your ass for nothing. I appreciate the fucking love, Krill. Thank you, man. Nigga, how do you niggas make this? How do people legit make these fucking... I mean, every time on Twitch, I come on here and I see these, like, these text arts. How to make text art. Is there a fucking app for this or something? Because I'm seeing way too... There's no way that there's somebody who actually is sitting there typing one symbol or icon at a time and actually able to piece this shit together, bro. I mean, I know it's a copy-paste, obviously, but, like, is there a place that you can just... Okay, is this it? Text to... Wait a minute. Text to ASC2 art generator? My nigga. Wait, so if I copy and paste this right now, will it really paste in? No way. Nah, I fucked it up. It didn't work. Okay, maybe I have to go to a different website. I was trying to see if I could get the hang of it, man. Like, yo, share y'all resources with me. I want to be able to shitpost a meme on here too while I'm at it, man. Like, fuck it. Nigga, give me the heads up. Wait, y'all crashed my chat already, bro? Niggas, stop crashing my fucking chat. That's the only way I know how the hell. That's the only way I know if y'all niggas are alive or not. TOS, it's got to be the right size. Man, fuck this. I'm out here. I give up. This shit is way too difficult, man. The memes used to be easier when I was younger, man. What the fuck are y'all on now? Okay, and what the fuck is this on now? Why? I mean, are we banned now? Is that it? I'm seeing the fucking. I'm seeing the Pepe face in this bitch too, man. Explanation point claim. What the hell? Yo, it's just straight up acid titties over here, man. Okay, so that's probably what wound up bounding us in the first place. The fact that niggas can get away posting all this crazy shit in here. But I mean, at the end of the day, it's pretty much harmless. I mean, we're just fucking around, man. Alright, so there's a little bit of a challenge here. This image. Alright, I love these things. Take a look at this. So it's, wait, look at the bottom right corner. Okay. Look at the umbrella pole. Look at the ocean. Look at her blush. And then, wait a minute, what kind of shit is this? This is not the first time that I've seen this gnome. Who is this guy? He reminds me of the, you better shut up before I slap your shit meme with the gnome on it. Like, where's that shit from, bro? I mean, if we get banned for this, that'll be pretty damn soft. Wait, didn't somebody get banned for something ridiculous recently, too, on Twitch? That was a pretty damn good meme. Thank you for sending that, man. Gnomed. There we go. Gnomed. There we go. Golly Mango, once again, thank bruh, the fact that niggas are donating that much is crazy to me, man. It's just like, I know it seems like I'm trying to bring it up just to fucking bait more, but no, like when I look to the side, I see these niggas with these crazy amounts, and once again, bro, I appreciate it from my heart, man. Etika, you've been gnomed. Really? So how does this meme work? Is it similar to like a Rickroll? Let's look this thing up real quick. I need to be caught up on these memes, man. I haven't been on it lately, man. Well, then again, this probably isn't really like a new meme anyways. Ha ha ha. Hoo hoo hoo. Hee 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 hee. Hello, Mio. This isn't helping me at all. This is not doing it for me. Is there like a know your meme page for this or something? You've been gnomed. Know your meme. Okay, here we go. Now we can get an explanation for it. So, here we fucking go, man. Should I whitelist these niggas? I don't really go to this website too much, bro. I mean, it's not really worth it, to be honest. But they are a meme resource. They have done a lot for the... He doesn't know? No, I was just curious. I want to see. You know what? I'm going to whitelist these niggas. Don't run on this page. All right, there we go. You happy, know your meme? You're going to make your fucking dollars off of me. Now, show me the fucking... Wait a minute. This guy's face. I've seen this nigga's face online too in a lot of places, man. Like, this is a whole meme. Didn't this shit involve KSI? Oh, and 21 Savage, bro. That nigga is still detained. Bro, so many things to talk about. But let me see here. Huh? Huh? Okay. It's one of those memes that I guess I don't really fucking have to fully understand. I just hope I never find it funny. Well, speaking of memes, I'm kind of curious. What have those Free Memes kids been up to lately? It's been a little while since I watched one of their compilations. Free Meme Kids. I remember you guys showed me this in one of the last streams I had done before the new year started. These niggas are apparently really, really good. Is that meme a thumbnail? No, that's 21. Okay. This is a 10-minute video. I mean, let's see. He got gnomed 3 times. Wait a minute. This is actually an official fucking Twitch thing? You have been gnomed. Type claim to stop your uncle from putting his pee-pee in your asshole. And this is a tweet. There's so many new mechanics on here, bro. Isn't there like a bit system or something too? Loud is, why is your forehead brighter than my future? It's because I slicked that bitch over, man. I had to make sure my skin was properly hydrated. You know what I'm saying? Free memes, kids. Let's see. Catch me up. I want to be brought up to speed as to what the deal is on these memes. Claim. Is that shit actually doing anything? Fucking normies. God damn it. Huh? That's the cutest fucking thing I've ever seen. Okay, I remember the rabbit one. Fuck, nigga. He's like my best pal. Jesus. Yo, Shaggy! This has been a meme too. Apparently he's...
Oh, these are pretty niggas. Cool.
Excuse me? What the fuck? Tyler actually... Is it because he's opening and closing at that shit fast? What the fuck? The Kool-Aid nigga? He actually did it! I think I might need to clip that. I can use that in some of my videos, nigga. Like, this nigga actually clipped the fucking nigga busting. Oh, yeah. Remember? He would be... Yeah. He comes through like this, nigga. Oh, yeah. Normie trash. Really? So Free Memes kids are now normie material? Oh. Oh, that's me.
Like, I don't mind, like...
Normie memes, yeah. Stick too hard, don't stand too close. You can take a lot of jizz on your face. On your toes. I haven't genuinely laughed yet, man. Etika, no? Why? Is this wrong? Is this the wrong place to get meme stuff now?
I needed that. I needed that too. The push in your luck, Scoob.
Hey, hey, hey. I remember seeing that before. These niggas with the scream. Alright, their reaction is good, but... Normie as fuck. Michael.
I like your nick.
Livestream fails for memes. YouTube memes are normie memes. I mean,
without even asking?
Holy shit! Did you just come in your sister?
You gotta be fucking kidding me.
Wait a minute. Wait a second. I feel like I've seen this nigga in the chat.
You are not the father.
What the hell? Nigga, fucking. Hold on a second. Hold on. Tell me how homeboy did a whole flip for it, bro. I remember sharing with you guys that clip where they play the Guile theme over the nigga in Maury, but some of these reactions are crazy. Homeboy legit did a motherfucking whole backflip, all because he wasn't the dad of this fucking baby, bro. Although I can't blame him. I mean, some of these situations on Maury, bro, I watch that shit every single morning, along with Jerry Springer, when I wake up with a bowl of mini-wheats, bro. And it's like, I prefer death before being on Maury, just saying, but I mean... Matt is God. Mods? I don't think there's any mods.
Bro, what?
There's no way! There's no way! Holy shit! Whose idea was that? Okay, I'm seeing that same fucking icon that I saw in this video in the fucking chat, man. Etika did not just say Jerry Springer. Yes, I did! I watch Jerry sometimes! What's the problem, nigga? Every now and then, I like to take in crap content too, man. You know, I never watched this movie? Hey. What happened to no Twitch niggas? We're breaking the rule one time.
Hold on, something's
they just flashed a shaggy.
Out of here. Look, there's a bird, dude. It knows what's good.
I remember this.
Tony, I just heard it inside.
Guys, cool it. Oh, it was shaggy. Never mind. Man, these shits are not hitting for me, bro. What's the deal? I thought they had it.
For people that are
not, I thought they had it, bro. Good one, YouTube. I don't know, bro. Go to Cowbelly's new channel. XD Breeze says, go to Cowbelly's. Okay, well, I'll check that out on the side while we try to attempt to salvage something out of this one. Not to be asshole to the free memes kids, but that last one isn't really hitting for me. Let me see. Cowbelly? Is this pop? Okay, wow, there's two channels, Common Awards and Cowbelly. 1 million subscribers. I actually am kind of looking for new YouTube content to take in a way to sort of get used to this new ecosystem before I make my shit banned again. Wait a second. I'm going to wait. Type. What the fuck? Type VIP Luke McGrith. Well, self-promo in the motherfucking chat or in the donation box, rather. I don't know what kind of fucking service you guys are subscribing to, but I mean, fuck, chat is not, we're not banned, shut the fuck up, niggas. I don't know, man. I'm surprised that we've lasted this long, man. Etika, close the chat. Nah, I'm not moving this, man. The chat is important, bro. Fuck that. I'm not leaving the chat out of this shit. The chat is part of this motherfucker. Let me see here. Cowbelly, I got a million subs. Okay, Soulja Boy video. Bonify came through to the stream with a $50 donation. I just got the video set up. He's saying, this is my first donation to you, Etika. I've been watching since you streamed Slendy Tubbies in 2016. I'm wondering if you can watch a video that I've been saving for when you finally came back. And he sent me a YouTube link. Bonify, thank you so much for the donation, man. I appreciate you. Bro, it's like getting back to YouTube after so long, man. Like, this is gonna be a trip. I've already planned what my first video will be, dogs. I don't want to tell y'all when it'll come out, though. Like, I just, things will happen when they happen. As frustrating as I know as that must be for some niggas, just be patient. Things will get to business when they need to, you know what I mean? Especially with Smash Brothers and stuff. I got a lot of stuff planned. Thank you very, very much for your contribution, though, Vonify. 2016 was a very different year from what 19 will be. This is the first year that I really have freedom, you know what I mean? So I'm ready to utilize that shit. But thank you for the link, too. I'm going to open this thing up real quick. Not the right channel. Let me see here. Soulja Boy. Hey, watch me crank that soldier boy to Superman at home. Watch me crank that soldier boy. 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 Crank that soldier bo It's not really a meme, though. It's a remix. That's kind of clean, though.
Hey, hey, hey. Think that's all good boy and Superman now.
Okay, let's check out Bonafide's video. Thank you once again, bro. Let me see. Etika News. I'm preparing for something in relation to Subway sandwiches and Minecraft. Wow, how high quality. Etika World Network indeed, huh? You know, that was kind of the...
Next up, we have breaking news. Etika has been seen in public playing Minecraft instead of Smash Brothers.
Really?
His last known location was in the Nether, and there is now a warrant for his arrest. So, if you see this man, contact 1-800
I wish my hair would be like that.
Footlongs to provide tips to catch this criminal.
I feel like by the time I want my hair to be that long in the first place, I'm already gonna be fucking bald, nigga. Like, fuck. I wouldn't mind, though. There's another nigga out there. I don't know. He's like this black dude who has like a big ass one, too. Niggas, I've shown him on the stream before. Apparently, he has a kid and all. But I'm going to be attempting to get my length to there, man. As you guys have seen, man, I've been working on the hair in the background. Boy, you look like a fucking Slim Jim. You know what?
Contact one. There is.
That was actually a pretty. I'm gonna screen cap that shit. Not a bad meme, man. I mean, these guys for hire, it's like Fiverr or some shit, right? Well, whichever service it is. These niggas who just take like this money and they make these random fucking videos. This one only has 17 views, so I'm guessing they must put out a lot of these shits. Etika, you're going to jail, nigga, for what? I've done a lot of things to take myself to jail over the years, though, man. You're going to have to clarify with me exactly which one it is. Thank you so much to whoever the hell just came through with that subscription in the box. Once again, I need to look that thing up. Have you guys seen the Aladdin thing? Oh my fucking God. Because there's a Will Smith, there's a movie. I think it's a Will Smith focused movie. And it's supposed to be him playing as the genie from Aladdin, bro. I saw a couple of screen caps on Twitter. And I knew for a fact that I wanted to wait until I was on a live stream to go more in depth with you niggas. It looks fucking crazy. I'm going to try to see if I can pull together some pics for you niggas. But I mean, they'll probably be easy. If we go over to the Moments tab, that shit will probably pop up. Maybe. I mean, I don't know. Will Smith. Okay, you know what? I'm just going to search it for y'all niggas right now. As a matter of fact, isn't there a YouTube trailer on this shit? I think there's a trailer. It's not just screenshots, right? Just from the fucking thing I saw, though. Alpha Rad, man. How's that boy been? Aladdin. 2019. Here we fucking go. Trailer 2 in Espanol. No. I mean, no understand that. But okay, one day ago with 2.2 million views. What's the like-dislike ratio looking like right now? Wow! 27,000 dislikes. Clearly, the people have spoken, man. Etika Loves Minecraft just came through with the subscription. Thank you, man. I can see that these memes truly will never die. My existence will just be haunted until the end of all time with these fucking references. Y'all just aren't gonna make this easy for a nigga, huh? Fuck me, man. But thank you anyways. As much as I appreciate the contribution and it coming from the heart, god damn it, it sends me to hell and back. But it's okay. I understand that that's how niggas need to vent off. Anyways, let's watch this fucking 2019 Aladdin trailer featuring Will Smith as a fucking blue man from the Blue Man Group. Nigga looking like a burger. What's a burger? Well, B-E-R-G-E-R. Ban Inconquer. I don't know what the fuck that means. Here we go. So what's worse, man, this or the fucking Sonic, the Sonic movie shit?
Bring me the lamp.
Your Jafar?
Begins now.
Please tell me the parrot's still going to shit talk.
Aladdin.
I don't remember his name, but... Bro, this movie looks nice, though. I mean, visual presentation. Damn, Jasmine! Okay. Everything looks good so far. Whoa. Here we go. The genie.
You really don't know who I am. Genie, wishes, lamp, none of that ringing a bell.
What the hell was that? What the fuck, nigga? Whoa, yo, that was CGI.
Wishes, lamp.
Bro, wait a second.
You really don't know who I am. Genie, wishes, lamp, None of that ringing a bell.
It looks a little weird having Will Smith in there, bro. I don't like it. I don't like it. He look like a Smurf, bro. Blue Thanos. Oh, shit. That nigga Will's about to snap up on niggas. Red Fair came through with the subscription, too. Thank you so much, Red. I appreciate you for that, man. And Vonify, I appreciate you for your donation earlier, too. Man, this fucking clip, I don't know. It's just a little weird. I mean, like, is it green screen? Or are they, like, using, like, the face mapping type thing to kind of just sort of... How did Thanos look so good in Infinity War, but Will Smith looks crazy in this? Maybe they got to get a better CGI guy. But keep Will Smith. I feel like he deserves to be in, like, a genie position in a way. This movie sort of puts me in mind of the whole Shazam thing. With the whole Mandela effect and all that. Thanos, Jin, it's not looking good so far, man. When is this supposed to come out? Let me see here. Aladdin 2019 release date. May 24th. All right, so within the month of my birthday, this is supposed to come out. I feel like I've always wanted to do sort of like a field trip with the niggas and we all go to one theater at some point, man. I don't know if I'm planning. I don't know if I'm going to do that necessarily, but I want to plan it at some point. It's on your birthday? Oh, shit. Well, I don't know. I'm not going to count it out just yet. It looks fucking crazy. If I had to go off a first response, I would say holy shit. But I mean, yo, that was only one part. The rest of it looked nice. And Jasmine, bro. They got a good actor for her. So I wouldn't say I'm out of it necessarily. I'm like a 7 out of 10 in terms of excitement for that shit. Although I didn't really grow up with Aladdin, so it doesn't really ring too home. But I mean, you know, I'll see it just because it's fucking Aladdin. Like, why the hell not? I remember watching the original one. Let's plan something for Avengers Endgame instead. From KYH9KY, I hope you've been good, bro. Let me see. How do I mod people if I really, really want to? Is there a way? Or do I just... Or am I just fucked? The YouTube Rewind? Oh, we already watched that one, man. And I had also seen PewDiePie. Holy fucking shit. Have y'all niggas seen the numbers with T-Series and shit? PewDiePie versus T-Series. There's a live streams and shit that keep track of this. What are the numbers looking like now?
Just this once.
Bob's or Vagon. Damn, nigga. Will it be? Alright, so I guess we're going to have to give up. Bro, what's going on, man? Is it really about to be time? Number one spot about to be given up to T-Series, my boy? What the fuck are we gonna do? I remember seeing earlier that apparently Felix had fucking played Roblox on a live stream, compromising his integrity for the sake of maintaining a subscriber stronghold over T-Series, and even that wasn't enough. Even Roblox Live wasn't enough. I mean, the only thing I can think of to help his numbers at this point is like him playing Fortnite or something. That's the only fucking way. These motherfucking Indians are coming for his neck, bro. I feel bad, but hey, if we got to give up the title, then that's just the way it was going to be. There's so many things that are passing on and changing hands, bro. As we live and age, bro, it's like, damn. For instance, do y'all niggas remember this ancient relic? I'm going to pull up something right now. It's going to pop up on the screen, and I want you niggas to tell me if you remember what this thing is, okay? In fact, I'm going to pull up two things. I want y'all to tell me if you remember these things. Both of these things are about to die. You feel me? Like, legit die. But I want y'all to tell me if you recognize them. Number one is this. Machinima. Number two is GameStop. Both of these niggas are done, bro. And what makes it crazy is that I remember a time where GameStop and Machinima, when it came to like gaming content online and IRL in terms of buying and shit, bro, these used to be companies all the way at the top of the fucking food chain. And now they're both out of here? Rest in pepperonis to Machinima and GameStop, bro? It's unfortunate. I mean, well, all right, let me not go there. Unfortunate? Hell no, man. Fuck GameStop. Listen, these niggas have been fucking over consumers like us for years. I remember being a little kid way back going to junior high school and reading in the fucking, well, okay, that wasn't really a bad memory. I have good and bad memories with GameStop. You know, it's not a full hate thing. They had great employees in some locations, but the trade-in values were just way too crazy, bro. How the hell you trade in a brand new game that you just bought and you get $10 for that bitch? Yeah, karma's a motherfucker, ain't it, man? Yeah, that's what y'all get, man. Circle of life having ass niggas. Fuck GameStop, man. Let me see it unanimous in the goddamn chat, man. Fuck GameStop. That's fucked up, though, because, I mean, there might be some people that have jobs and stuff, and it's unfortunate. I mean, there will be people out of work. And, you know, things are changing all over the place, man. Once again, Machinima, they on top of a lot of other YouTube networks, man, are out of here. Apparently, the tides are turning, and... Bro, wait a second. So this is Machinima now? Personalized talent management services help our creators navigate the gaming industry, freeing them to focus on bringing their vision to life for millions of fans. Bro, that is clearly a bullshit motherfucking blurb. GameStop is legit. Screw Attack? I forgot about Screw Attack. Mistaken came through. Thank you, Mistaken. The Wii shop. I forgot. Bro. Oh, no. This is going to be a... Rest in peace. Rest in fucking peace. Yo, can we take a moment to just put one of these in the chat? To represent the last time that we had decent fucking virtual console, man. Thank you. Thank you, Nintendo. Now, if only y'all niggas could bring some form of this to the fucking Switch, that'd be great. I don't know about y'all, but I'm getting a little bit tired of these NES games on the fucking eShop with this goddamn membership on the Switch with the fucking online. I mean, come the hell on. F in the chat, please. Damn it, man. It's too bad. We lost a real soldier. We lost a real soldier when the Wii Shop went down. Blast that shit. Turn that shit all the way up. Turn that shit up. Thank you so much, Soldier Boy, tell him, for the subscription in here. Once again, I don't mean to keep missing on the subscriptions, but the thing is, I don't know where your fucking money is going, my boy. These things keep popping in, and it's like, I don't have a partnership on this motherfucker. I'm literally just streaming out of nowhere, man. I don't have anything going on for me over here. Oh yeah, that was, well, okay, that wasn't porn. Twitch, okay, take a good look. Everything's covered up, okay? This is a meme, all right, Twitch? Don't ban me for this. God damn it. Anyways, I just wanted to make sure that they understood that. But bro, let me see here. Am I still good? Am I still live? We're still live, nigga. Oh, shit. No, we're not banned just yet, man. Don't rush the process. It'll happen naturally, okay, my boys? I'm not trying to waste the night away. I just got started in this bitch, man. Let me see. I want to see some sort of GameStop news video in a way. There was some stuff that was talking about the method as to how GameStop went down, and some of it's crazy, bro. Like, they're desperate now. I think another company is buying them. And what happened to Screw Attack, too? Let me see here. People told me to look them up. I think they're going down. I used to watch a lot of their videos, too. Oh, Death Battle! Wait a minute! Screw Attack was Death Battle. They made it separate. Oh shit, bro. Maybe this didn't just happen. Maybe this isn't like a new thing. You know what I mean? It could very well be that I'm late. I mean, it's probably that I'm late. But I mean, bro, I didn't realize that everything had kind of come to an end with these niggas. So they're still only doing Death Battle videos? Are they still getting views? Death Battle's kind of getting... Okay, I mean, bloopers, okay. Where's like a main Death Battle? Aquaman versus Namor. Okay, 5 days ago, 1.2 million views. That's not bad.
You can
look
discover
at that, man. Time did not waste these niggas. Even with Screw Attack going down, Death Battle is still big in the scene. But you know what this brings me in mind of, man? Yo, man, what old school YouTubers did you dudes used to watch back in the day? I mean, I can think of one right off the top, man. Angry Joe. That used to be a channel that I watched all the time. I mean, I probably was subscribed to him, but I lost it because, you know, this is a whole new YouTube channel here. But, bro, how's Angry Joe been? I've not checked out this. Tobuscus? Oh, my God, yo. Bro, y'all are... This nigga... You know the gif where that nigga Neil deGrasse Tyson is like... No. I can pull it up. I can pull the gif up. Hold on. deGrasse Tyson gif. I know y'all niggas know what this image is. Yes, bro. When I was reading the fucking names that y'all niggas put in the chat of old school YouTubers, I was going through a fucking... like a blast to the past, my nigga. Holy shit, some of these names are old. Max Mofo. Bro, Max isn't a dead channel, or is he? Well, no, nobody's channel is deader than mine, okay? Nobody can match my numbers. Zero videos with almost 200,000 subs. You ain't fucking with me, okay? I welcome it. Okay, let's see here. Koban Armani 456. You think you're clever, huh? They think they're clever.
Y'all not funny. Y'all not getting the slip on me. Oh, by the way, you know, just okay. So what kind of tabs do I have open here? Let me just check my stuff. Angry Joe, I was gonna take a look at how his channel is doing. Yeah, okay, I didn't subscribe to, you know, this new one. What other tabs do I have here? Oh, wait, never mind. I already have his channel open. Wait, never mind. No, I don't. Okay, we're gonna close this. Zendo, thank you for your subscription, man. I didn't get a chance to see it, and it's not showing up on my list, so I think it's in a separate fucking window or something. But thank you very, very much for that, wherever it's going. I mean, I guess Twitch is taking a cut. What's this? Oh, the Etika News video. Yeah, that was real clever. This one, I was kind of jamming a little bit, but I lost my patience, and it wasn't all that good. The best memes, man. These free memes, kids. Y'all really think I should give this video a chance, or should I just throw it in the motherfucking bin? We were kind of already halfway through. I wanted to get somewhat of a laugh tonight. I guess we're going to have to devolve to going to the dark places online, like the YNC live leak and live stream fails. I don't necessarily want to have to go that route on Twitch because, you know, no Twitch niggas, obviously. I mean, I mean, even though I was joking and I said maybe I'll get banned in the middle of the stream, I'm having a good time right now in this motherfucker with y'all niggas, okay? Yes, the YNC. Okay, now that's how I know you're fucked up. Look at this nigga. Y'all want to see something funny in the chat? This nigga Dip Talk, or whatever the fuck his name is, he said yes to the YNC. My friend, do you know what kind of website that is? I was joking, all right? The YNC is a horrible place. Who the fuck would want to go there? Not necessarily. All right, and let me get this disclaimer out the way. I am not telling you to go to the YNC. But the fact that some people are like, yes, that's a horrible website, bro. Y'all niggas got problems, man. But then again, you know, I'm the one that brought it up. I mean, okay, do you want to know something crazy? I would always... Oh, okay, I shouldn't say always, but when I was younger, right? God, this is gonna make me look so crazy. I'm not a psychopath, okay? I'm just telling you, sometimes, rarely, maybe once like a year or something, back in the day, we would have, me and my closest friends, we would have what's called a YNC night, where we go to the website and we watch like a bunch of shock videos and all that. But the thing is, some of the videos would be like overly grotesque. And I mean, like, I don't want to see somebody with their fucking face open, but they would have like generally other shocking videos, and they had a lot of sexual stuff too on there. So we would always go on there and just like kind of test our gangster in a way, solidify our resolve by watching shock and wild ass videos. What the fuck were we thinking? Ben, do you remember those old days? We called them shits the YNC nights. They said all teenage boys used to do that. Really? Am I the only one? I can't find excitement watching gore, but some of those videos would be wild. You know what I mean? The cow freaking died. Oh yeah, I think I might have talked about this before. The cow, bro. That shit is still in my mind. I'm mad that y'all remember that. That's how I know some of y'all niggas are the realest ones in here. Niggas are like, wait a minute, the cow video, bro. You told us. Yeah, that it disturbed me. All right. Let me, before I move on to the next subject, take a look at how my Twitter page is looking. It's been so damn litty lately, man. Valentine's Day coming up, bro. You know I had to share Valentine's Day love on the timeline and all that. You take a look at this. Xenoblade Chronicles 2. You know that's that biter. And she's cooking up a hot meal, my boy. Take a look at... Yo, this is such a hot image! Like, bro, I had to retweet this! I know! I'm horny on main, but guess what, bro? I ain't ashamed. I am a man! I am a man! What do you want from me? That's nice! Yes, my boy! It's clean, man! Oh, boy! Oh yeah, Kingdom Hearts 3 also came out recently, too. That's a really, really hot title. Have any of you guys been playing that one? I haven't. I know for a fact that there's a lot of people that are jumping to the game without playing the others, and I don't know about that one. That's a no-no. Did you see the drama lately? Oh, I'm gonna... Y'all, are y'all ready? I want you dudes to do something for me. Make sure that you put on your cringe jacket, okay? Put on your cringe jacket, your cringe helmet, your cringe coat, all right? We are about to go deep. Actually, no, you know, fuck the cringe shit. Put on your anti-salt assemble, okay? Ensemble. We are about to go into the deepest levels of salt on the motherfucking internet right now. And I think a goddamn nigga knows this shit in the chat right here. Okay. All right. Niggas are saying Kingdom Hearts 3 is trash. What? Bro, Leffen said some shit along those lines on Twitter the other day. Bro, okay, let's see if we can find this. Because this nigga was doing hella explaining after he made that original post. Where the fuck is it? Alright, bro, look at all this explaining he was doing. February 8th. You know this nigga felt shook. The Kingdom Hearts community came for his giblets, bro. And they ain't letting go of them shits. February 8th, this nigga's explaining. Yo, Leffen, bro. Listen, I wouldn't wish this on my worst enemy, okay? To take the fucking fury of a fan base that's waited 13 years for their content, bro. That's almost as bad as insulting niggas who've waited a month for mine. Like, come on, bro. Anyways, the actual post that he made was here. Where is that shit at? Where was it? The 8th? Boom, boom, boom. I almost found it. I think I'm close. Talking about... okay, I think I missed it earlier, but I was... Here we go. All right. Kingdom Hearts 3 is an actual 3 out of 10 game. I have not played the prior games, but honestly, I'm happy I didn't, because waiting 13 years for a story and gameplay this garbage would have fucking ended me. The graphics, dialogue, combat, and all shit. Cutscenes and voice acting are all shit, and it costs $70. I told you, my nigga. Yeah, some of y'all might not be ready for this. That was a mouthful. Thank you so much to that person who just fucking subbed to me. I feel horrible that I keep missing that, man. Yeah, y'all niggas. I got once again. I gotta fix out what's going on with that shit so I can properly acknowledge the niggas who are being the lifeblood in this motherfucker. But I mean, yeah. What do you guys think? It's not wrong, really. It's not wrong, Radiating says. Oh no, is he lying? Leffen is a boss. Any truers? Damn, was Leffen really on it? Was Kingdom Hearts? What are the reviews for Kingdom Hearts 3? What are the scores, bro? 85 on Metacritic, 9 out of 10, 4 out of 5. These are really good scores, guys. Is the game really that bad of a game? He's wrong, boy. He's wrong as, excuse me, what did you say, bro? He's wrong. Da, 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 true. All right. So here we go. We're going to have to do a little bit of a test here. Even though I don't know a damn thing about Kingdom Hearts other than the first game, and clearly that's not enough knowledge to understand Kingdom Hearts 3, I'm going to still make a straw poll anyways. I want to see where the Joy-Con boys stand. You know what I'm saying? So let's go on here and gauge Kingdom Hearts 3. KH3, good or bad? Da 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 da. Da 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 da. Hey, straw poll complete, my boys. I just do it in the chat. Please let me know what your opinions are. I mean, if you don't see it in the chat, try to scroll up, my nigga. I tried my best. I have no regrets. I can't make that shit stay there. Hey, sweet dreams. Hey. Okay, so let's see the results. Someone said to watch Dunkey's video on Kingdom Hearts 3. Maybe that'll give us a little bit of perspective. Also, I meant to check out Angry Joe. Hey, Y89, my fucking nigga. I saw you in the chat, and now I see you with the stacks. He says, Etika, I am moving soon. I'm happy for you, man. You're joining the club the same way I was. Thank you so much for the fucking love all this time. I'm surprised that you have the ability to move now, too, considering the stacks you spent on me. But hey, maybe we both found good fortune, right? He says, where should I move to hang out with you? KY, it's been a long time, bro. You know the shit that we got going on at this point. I'm taking you semi-seriously, my boy, so watch what you say. You might wind up living with a nigga, and Lord knows nobody in the stream wants to live with me in an intimate setting at any point, right? I mean, he says, did you see that Xenoblade Chronicles 2 is getting an extra art book? Check Japanese Amazon. Hold on a second. You know I gotta see that, man, to clearly acknowledge and appreciate the waifu in the game. Nothing out of the ordinary or sexual by any means. It's just educational purposes. Xenoblade Chronicles 2, extra art book. Or maybe I'll just search art book while I also balance looking at Angry Joe. While I also balance looking at Kingdom Hearts 3 fucking reviews. While I also try to figure out why the hell I keep missing out on all these fucking wonderful, completely caring, selfless fucking subscribers and shit, nigga. Fuck. Oh, and Dunkey too. You know what? Let's open up Dunkey real quick. I know some of y'all would love to say that sentence. Dunkey, Kingdom Hearts. Wow, that motherfucker popped up right away. Damn, is it really that bad, my nigga? Okay, well, let's see what the fucking deal is. And also, y'all see the Powerline shirt out here? Eye to eye, my boy. As a matter of fact, before we continue, I definitely gotta jam out because this used to be my shit. Eye to eye, Goofy Movie. If you do not remember this song, then you, my friend, did not have a childhood. Real talk.
Science slumber party.
Hey, turn that shit up. This movie was so lit!
Some people
There's different things. Living on the line, swinging in the wings. It ain't a question of if, just a matter of how. Hey! 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 That power line, boy. Hey, above the crowd, even if I gotta shout out loud. Sometimes I'm the only face you see. Gonna. Hey, 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 yo, this is the be my shit. Yo, watch the moonwalk. Watch the moonwalk.
If I could make you stop and take a look at me instead of just walking by.
Oh, hey, my nigga. I just launched my headphones, actually. DesoFag came through with another donation. This is another stream regular. Deso, thank you so much for the love, bro. He says, Leffen is autistic and he's garbage in Smash Brothers for real FX. Dogs, I don't know. I was watching a little bit of Leffen footage earlier. The nigga's Pokemon trainer is kind of crazy. Boy, be switching up in the middle and dodging moves with the shit. I mean, I think his placement in Genesis was pretty damn high too, right? I mean, I can't really speak on the Leffen situation. I feel like he's being really mean towards that game, but at the same time, there's a lot of expectations that happen with it. We saw this with Final Fantasy 15. Niggas are probably had a bunch of fucking expectations, and none of those happened the way that they thought, so now the game ain't all that good. I mean, seems typical, but I think it's still a good game. I feel like it's still a good game. It had good reviews from what we've seen. I guess just maybe the more, I don't know, maybe more of the hardcore fans weren't crazy about it, but that's just a guess. I obviously don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. But hey, what the fuck is this? Is this from my headphones? Yes, it is. I completely knocked this whole thing off while I was getting down a power line, man. Can you blame me? The Goofy movie had some bangers. That's just how it is. If y'all don't understand it, then you just weren't fortunate enough to be born when I was. I'm just playing. I don't know how to fix these. I'm just going to put this thing on and hope for the best. There we go. Throw that motherfucker on there. Hold on a second. Another donation. Hold on a second, boys. Y'all niggas are really wilding out here, man. Thank you, man. Yo. Of course, it's fucking God. Green HS, man. Coming through to the stream once again. Thank you, man. I appreciate you so much, Green. He says, yo, Etika, man, it's great to hear your voice again. Thank you. Even though I can't exactly say the same for you doing the stream thing, but the time that we did spend when you were here in New York was great. I never really did anything with the pumpkin either, nigga. So, yeah, I guess that's just a memory that will exist. Hey!
Boom! I got whatever it takes.
It's a piece of cake. Hey, to stand out. Above the crowd, even if I got down. Oh, bro, this is my shit. Green. I don't know when we're going to see each other next, bro, but DesoFag came through with a $50 donation right after that one saying Mewtwo King is the best Melee player. Isn't it actually our motto right now? Although we all love Mewtwo King, man. Is he playing some? Well, I'm guessing he is. Who does M2K mean? I mean, I know a lot of these guys are doing Wolf and Pichu and all these standard, typical over... Well, I wouldn't say overpowered, but, you know, overused characters and shit, man. I don't know. It's like, I can't really get behind the overused ones. I've been using a lot of Robin lately, man. They buffed this chick, bro. So she's moving fast now. She's got... Well, they kind of nerfed her arc fire in one way, but they buffed it in another. I've been doing a lot of Smash. We haven't done Smash yet, and I know for a fact there's follow Zondo on Twitter. Okay, never mind. That was just a fucking self-ad completely, but I mean, it's still a fucking subscriber, so thank you, man. And check Twitch DMs also came through with a subscription. I don't know if this is actually somebody paying for something. Maybe it's something else I'm missing out on completely, but thank you very, very much to all of y'all niggas for the love, man. I appreciate every single one of y'all while I fix these fucking headphones. I was supposed to take a look at this art book that Xenoblade has coming out for it, man. I have not gotten a chance to catch up with any of this stuff. Etika, are you part of the plant gang? Bro, you know what's funny? My friend Ray, he plays Piranha Plant, but I'm not. I thought I would pick it up. I mean, and it's definitely a good character. Wow, this is nice. So this is gonna have more artwork than what was originally featured in the one that because guess what, I do have the original special edition with the artwork that was in this.
Now, because I sank so many fucking hours into Xenoblade Chronicles 2, I, just for having like a sentimental connection to the game, I bought this thing, but it has an art book too. But it damn sure doesn't have a cover like this one does, man. I mean, to be honest with you, I prefer the art book with the waifu on it rather than this. Although this is pretty badass too, you know, not everything has to be waifu'd out, but I'm just saying, you would have gotten more sales with this one. So that's probably why they're putting one out in the first place, man. You know what I really wish I did get my hands on, but I didn't, which was like a special edition sort of rare exclusive collectible type thing for Xenoblade Chronicles 2? I never got a chance to get that fucking Zohar USB stick thing, man. Like, and then to buy one, you have to fucking spend like $1,000 on eBay. I am not trying to get fucked in the ass by no sharks online, man. Fuck that. Fuck that. I just moved, man. You know how expensive this place was, dogs? I'm good money, bro. Fuck. Cranium PK came through with $50 as well. Niggas are out here right now. He's saying, yo, Etika, flat top is on point, my boy. I have to cut it with samurai sword, nigga. Yo, shout out to Steve the Barber, though. That's my dude, actually. So if you want to know. Although, I actually took a picture with him on Instagram, so check that. He says, can you check out my Pokemon track with GE Revive? This is probably not as good as the Goofy music video, though. Well, I mean, I'm glad that you acknowledge that. Thank you very, very much, PK, for the fucking 50. GE's actually somebody that I fucks with heavy, man. He was in the other ciphers too and shit. Thank you for the fucking link, man. I'll check it out a little bit. I don't know. I mean, is it heat or not? Did you rap trash or not on it, man? Don't mean to be mean, but I'm just saying, bro. It's a real world. We gotta be real. Do you think that this is some of your best work or nah? Because whichever it is, it's about to be seen on here. I know GE will come with the flames, but what about you, my nigga? Let me put this damn thing away, bro. I meant to look up a little bit more stuff about Kingdom Hearts 3, but y'all know my sentiments, man. I don't think the game necessarily is trash, like he was saying. I just don't think it was probably all it was cracked up to be, too. You know? Like 15. I can't put this thing back. Too much work. Whatever. CD-ROM 1019, bro. There's somebody else that I have not gotten a chance to talk to yet that I know you're probably going to mention. He says, good to see you again, man. Thank you for the welcome back, CD. It's been a long time, and I'm glad to be here. This is my natural element, man. Now I just got to get back into it, you know? Get back into the regular swing. Finally have my own space. Now it's time to make the race and hopefully not get locked up the way TK did. And speaking of which, 6ix9ine, bro. RIP. Did y'all hear the news? Apparently, 6ix9ine, well, there's so many things that I'm balancing and juggling right now, but CD-ROM says, wondering how you were doing earlier today, but I'm hoping that you and Alex do something for Switch-iversary 2 next month. I have something for you two. Let's catch up soon when you're finally settled. Syracuse is calling your name, brother. Yo, CD-ROM, once again, man, we definitely have to talk at some point in the future, bro. Thank you for the fucking love, as usual. I know me being caught up in the past, we didn't really get a chance to, like, one-on-one, but we'll get our chance to soon, man. You know, your boy was caught up. That's all I can say, man. Life comes in, man. Life grabs you by the nuts, and sometimes you gotta go with that bitch, or otherwise you get them pulled off. You know what I mean? Be water, my friend. Go with the flow, my nigga. Thank you, though, man. In terms of Alex, CND. Hold on a second. Thank you for that donation. Give me a moment. Yo, Ninfall came through. Alex, CND.
Nigga, we made it.
Boom. All right, so Alex, I haven't really heard too much from the dude. As you can see on his page, he's sort of got a little bit of a theme as to what I have going on. I'm just going to clarify this right now so nobody jumps to conclusions. I don't know what the deal is. I've talked to Alex a little bit, but I think he's going through some transitional stuff on his own. So, I mean, hey, hopefully the guy will be okay. I don't know too much about it, though, so that's what my stance is. But, you know, he's my boy, and he knows I have his back. I haven't seen him too much recently. Ninpalk, he has my back, too, apparently. Thank you for your 50. Thank you for your contributions. That's fucking usual, man. You know damn well how much this shit means to me. That was a driving force behind me getting this motherfucker in the first place. You know what I mean? We're having a chill stream tonight. Nothing crazy planned. I'm not trying to wild the fuck out, but I just wanted to do something to just get back on base with my niggas, you know what I mean? And it feels good to be on here, bro, even on the platform that I absolutely despise. One way or another, it's all the same at the end. I get a message across to my niggas pull their dicks out. Pause. Yeah, they always pulling your dicks out in the goddamn chat, man. Oh yeah, and thank you for reminding me, about Donkey too. I gotta check out this track that Cranium has sent me, but for now, this playlist is old too. I gotta update this shit. Donkey, Kingdom Hearts. Did I look this up yet or not? I don't fucking know. We have 2 days ago this was posted. 2.6 million views. Holy fucking shit. Well, then again, this is regular for Donkey. Let me make sure I have all this other stuff closed out. Alex, man, if you're watching this, hopefully you're good, my boy. Let me check my Twitter notifications real quick. See what the fuck niggas have been up to. All right, what's this? Six-year-old me. A third gummy vitamin, even though the box says you can only have two. Yeah. I can, that was me at some point, man. Those things tasted good. You ever tried the Flintstone gummy vitamins, man? I know damn well those probably aren't the best thing to eat all in a row, but fuck it, man. I did it. That was me. Let me see. Howler Von Baron came through with a $50 donation, man. Howler, excuse me. Thank you so much, bro. He says, bro, welcome back to, I don't know. It sounds weird to say welcome back to Twitch, but welcome back. Have you seen this animation? Well, let's see. Is this a troll or what? Something about Smash the World of Light animated. Loud sound warning. This is definitely something I'm going to watch on stream. This just sounds like something I would watch on stream. Etika, check your Twitter DMs. I can't check my Twitter DMs right now, nigga. Do you know what kind of fucking controversial stuff I have in there? I have some DMs right now. I mean, okay, do you want me to say something to y'all niggas right now in terms of like the whole like inner peace woke stuff or whatever? I mean, I don't want to dwell too much on that shit, but in terms of my fucking well, what happened to me, there are a lot of YouTubers that some of you niggas might know that had actually messaged me and were like, yo, same thing happened to me. It's a little bit weird. I think what YouTube does is help to facilitate the discovery of, I guess, truths about yourself by, you know, maybe there's some YouTubers that live really, really good lives, and because they have, I mean, I wouldn't say really, really good lives. There's some YouTubers that have a lot, some that don't have as much. I'm the one, I have decent, but I don't have as much. But I feel like with YouTube helping people to realize maybe some of their dreams and having their passions there, maybe that's the reason why some of these other niggas woke too in a way. Because some niggas with clout messaged me, bro. I'm never going to ever say who it is, but holy shit. To know that some niggas of this size were like, yeah, Etika, same thing happened to me. Only difference was it wasn't on my social media. It's like, fuck! What's going on here, man? This world is crazy, bro. But hey, we're not. Y'all ain't here to hear about that. What am I about to do? Delete my whole fucking Twitch again? The YouTube channel's already gone, nigga. What else is there to delete? Don't you worry, man. Everything here is just fine. No, I won't hit the delete button on anything else in here, okay? I damn near hit the delete button on my existence, considering how long I was gone. But, you know, I'm all right. I'm good, man. I didn't want y'all niggas to worry too much. The Kingdom Hearts thing. Let's see where our votes were in terms of the stream. Wait a minute. Did I actually fuck up that shit? Okay, so slightly more for bad. I mean, this is a lot of good, too. I'm not going to jump on the hate wagon for this shit, man. I mean, expectation wagon, yeah, but hate wagon, not really necessary. All right, we're going to turn off this weird-ass Five Nights at Freddy's music, which is playing for some reason. So you know this playlist is old. And I'm going to hear what this Revive track sounded like real quick from my boy Cranium PK. Cranium, you know damn well the streams move fast, man. I can't necessarily give it a hell of a lot of time, but I'm damn sure going to see what the motherfucking hooks sound like. Nigga, throw that shit on. Let me see. G-E's my boy, though. So I'm fucking ready. Let's watch Donkey. Holy shit. I watch Donkey when I want to watch Donkey. Let me hear the chorus.
Now you know it made me faint, so I used up a Revive. Opened her legs, then I saw the fucking ocean. So you know I finna dive. And look at tongue Arceus level, it gave me that growth that brought me into overdrive. Her waterfall, one of my bullets, he's super effective. So you know I give her 5. Hey. You're switching, hey. I'm hitting, she twitching.
Hey.
Up in my heart, and you know that she be licking.
Hey. I
have a vision, becoming the champion, that is my mission.
It's not trash, it's decent. In the kitchen. It's decent.
Bite, let the fuckers start itching. 6-0, cause you know that I'm winning. I'm a king with my AZ flow, and you ain't got no clout cause you're an unknown.
Not
booked up, not like my champ. My body made of stone, evolving on the track just like my body made a mega stone. Okay. Snakes on my feet like Survivor, like Charmeleon.
Alright, it ain't the greatest I've heard, but it's definitely not bad, man. Yo, keep it going though, that's the thing. Don't stop early, just because niggas maybe don't vibe with it heavy right away. Bro, it could still turn out being good. Just train yourself, man. Keep on doing it. Don't fucking give up. You're not in a bad position. Trust me, I've heard way worse. And speaking of bad rappers who Well, I shouldn't say bad rappers. You're not a bad rapper. But speaking of somebody who also has controversy in terms of their rap style, or at least they did, and I know I have to watch the Dunky shit. There's really a lot of heavy hardcore Dunky fans inside of this stream chat, huh? A lot of y'all in here just like the fucking JoJo and the fucking BTS fans in here. So am I about to have my stream chat completely dominated by Dunky niggas telling me to watch his video? How strong is the Dunky niggas in here? You know what? As a matter of fact, let's just like leave it on standby and see just how many of y'all can spam my shit by the time the stream ends. That's so torturous. It's like, nigga, I know damn well I'm gonna get spammed with this shit now, but whatever. Thank you also once again to the subscription that I was not able to see. Howler Von Baron, I have the animation here that you wanted me to check out. I was supposed to be looking through my Twitter shit real quick. This thing is good. I'm gonna close this. Angry Joe, this is another guy I'm supposed to check out. Let's just real quick, before I get caught up in changing subjects once again, see how this man's channel has been doing, bro. Joe seems like he's good, man. One point, okay, so his angry reviews still get a lot of views. I remember there was like a little bit of controversy with this guy before because people were like, yo, you're not putting out enough angry reviews for us and shit like that. But I mean, seems like he's good now. I'm happy for my nigga, man. Let's see what his latest video is looking like.
So over the weekend,
the mohawk. I guess it's not really a mohawk. This little lick of hair sticking out in the middle. Okay, I can fuck with it, Joe. How's Texas treating you, nigga?
Yeah, it's not.
Egg, you stall too much, bro. The streams have been stalled since 2015. I mean, you know, this is kind of the thing that I did. You know, just come on this motherfucker and bullshit. You know what I mean? He's pretty active on Twitch still. Wow, okay. My nigga Joe is still doing his thing, man. I'm happy for him. Bruh, he managed to survive the politically correct era. I mean, it seems like his angry reviews are getting the views, and that's the most that matters. You know what I mean? Oh, wait a minute. You know what? Let me catch up real quick with some other niggas since we have a little bit of time and nothing else to do in the schedule. You know what I mean? I'm kidding. Nimpulk, you had come through earlier, and I did not get a chance to read what your message said, bro. So let me actually take a look real quick. He says, sorry, Etika, we have to appreciate Twitch more now. I haven't heard the news about, haven't you heard the news about Nintendo partnering with Twitch? Ooh, okay. This is legit. All right. Let's move on to the next subject. We had another subscription that I just didn't get a chance to see once again, man. I gotta go into the control panel, but thank you very much for the fucking sub. Let me see here. Where was I? I lost my topic. I was going to check out some other channels, like some other old school ones from back in the day, but let me see. I'm gonna close this. There's a couple of things. Oh yeah, Scott the Waz. I was supposed to check out one of his videos on the live stream too. Leffen, we're done with you, man. The controversy, we're good. Let me see. Let me close this one. All right, I'm actually gonna check out the Dunky one now, and then I'll check out this animation afterwards. Let me see. Boom, boom, boom. thousand dislikes. All right, so this video isn't really like a, I guess this has like a good perception of it. What the fuck? Dunky hates RPGs apparently. Is that true? I don't want to believe that. Niggas rickrolled me in 2019, bro. You're not clever for that, though, Nimpulk, you see? The fact that you even sent me a Rickroll in the first place. Do you know what that does for your credibility, my boy?
Huh? Now we get to play the game. Finally, we get... You know, after we learn about expert... Here we go. Alright, what is this now?
Is this a thing?
I'm actually...
It just always pops the menu up like that?
Just skip... Wait.
Bro!
I should read this.
Is this edited, my nigga? Oh, okay, this has to be edited.
This is one of the biggest glumber fucks I have ever witnessed.
Bro, this game looks crazy.
So much hard work wasted on a product so astonishing.
What? It's that bad? Oh my god. That's the tutorials, yeah.
Beyond Me, Square places all of its chips on the story, which is possibly one of the worst yet in a video game. There was so much expository dialogue, so many back-to-back scenes of characters explaining what is happening, and still, you are just completely lost.
Oh, really?
There is no sense of cohesion. Scenes just happen with no logic or reason behind
it. What the hell?
Stacks one plot hole.
It's that bad?
Playing fucking Jenga.
The story, that is?
Riku quested through the sleeping world. Riku
Whoa.
Secret research data.
I okay. Thank you once again for the sub, mysterious stranger who I missed out on.
Was ready to face the hurt that you carry inside.
I do know hurt.
I do know hurt.
But far worse than being a convoluted mess, the game is boring.
Really?
It's really boring. The dialogue is so
the combat looks so fast as shit.
So robotic that it's.
Is this like a satire type video? Is this like a troll? Emotion.
The few exceptions like Hades and Rex are trampled over by a horde of fucking cyborgs.
Huh? Replicas. Huh? Alright, this is a heads up, man. Going into this, I have no... I haven't really played too much of Kingdom Hearts 3. So, I mean, even though he's telling me these points, I can't really say they hit home. But, I mean, well, damn. This isn't what I would hope for a fucking 13-year anticipated game, nigga. Dunk views are serious.
You wouldn't remember. The replicas will become people.
Rather than show you things happening, they just talk about stuff that already happened. And when they aren't explaining some major event that the player missed out on, they're spouting cryptic bullshit or making anime sounds with these long, awkward pauses.
Huh? Once again, yeah, I'm not a nigga. Like, fuck, bro. I mean, these niggas, they really try to implement that kind of shit into this, man. I mean, bro.
As a genius,
that's kind of corny. Device, that's kind of corny. I'll admit.
Amnesia and forgot
for me.
The Kingdom Hearts games that nobody played, but so did everybody.
He hates Xenoblade.
For some people, and the entire goal of the game.
A lot of people hate Xenoblade, so I'm okay with that.
Waking, but then he forgot about that.
So, Sora, is there a reason you guys are visiting?
Oh yeah.
It sounds like somebody forgot.
Why do you think we come here?
Got me, Donald.
Isn't there this joke with Donald in terms of like this thing that he says all the time? I don't remember exactly what it is, but somebody had, like, well, I'd seen somewhere on Twitter, like, this meme where somebody, like, repeated this thing that Donald always says, and it's had something to do with, like, cooking or whatever. Like, what the fuck was it? Ingredients! There we go! This nigga's always talking about that. Apparently, it's like the, you know, in Final Fantasy 15, Ignis would always bring up, like, oh, I just got a new recipe. So, it's something like that with Donald. Ingredients. It's in the video. Oh, okay. I guess I spoke too soon.
There is no structure, no stakes. The villains are completely aimless.
Really?
Nobody seems to know anybody or understand what their motivations are. Huh? During the loading screen, Riku was tweeting about how he is in the shadow world with the hashtag Realm of Darkness.
What? And
Dylan, the two you knew as...
It's an actual tweet. It's like a social media platform. Again.
Aqua fell into the monster realm of darkness after she dove in to save Terra.
I don't know what you're saying.
Well, I think we might be going in circles.
Zondo, thanks.
Hart took his master's name, Ansem, and traveled to the past to give his younger self instructions.
What's going on?
But all the while, young Xehanort had been visiting the future to choose 13 vessels of his own.
Guys,
I guess I'm being spoiled a little bit.
Xemnas?
Oh, he's with them.
Not anymore.
Actually, he might have been friends with another version of you. Do you even...
Can y'all tell me something? Am I confused just because of the fact that I didn't play the Kingdom Hearts before? Or is the actual story really as convoluted as Donkey's trying to make it seem in this?
Realize what you are saying?
A heart can live anywhere, even inside Data.
Darkness.
What?
Gameplay-wise, there is an ambitious...
Is it really that complicated? How bad could this story be complicated? I mean, how complicated could it really be?
Shooter, then you're collecting 300 crabs, then it's a rhythm...
There's only three games, right? Kingdom Hearts 1, 2, and 3. Star Fox, then you... Alright, I know damn well there's more than three.
It doesn't do anything particularly well, but it does a lot of things. The combat is easily the most fleshed out, but for all the fancy moves at your disposal, nothing feels as effective as mashing the X button...
Read the wiki, you'll be less confused.
In a game,
well, no way I got time for that.
Cutscenes, the lengthy canned animations and combat make it feel like you're still watching a movie.
It reminds me of a promise I made.
To who?
Just someone I once met. Can't tell.
Wow.
Sounds like a good memory.
I'm just like reading the chat a little bit while in the middle, and it's like, damn.
Exploring the environments, they look great.
These messages. Thank you for the subscription, my friend.
And the music is enchanting. You know.
Okay, so that's good. And there it is. He says it so slow. This might be a good spot to find some ingredients. It's dragged out like for a year, nigga.
Diehard fans who really invested in the overarching story of the previous titles will be happy to know that they just dump all of that shit straight into a garbage bin so that Sora can go dick around with a bunch of Disney characters. And it's here, in these episodic segments, that you can see just how fast this team's vapid approach to storytelling unravels.
Really?
So we made a copy of the world and then pulled those hearts apart.
I'm confused. Mm-hmm. Did he say he made a copy of the real world?
What?
Only one of the worlds is real. And all the is just really convincing.
You can't be serious. Oh, that's right. You're from a video game.
The frozen levels are literally just three major scenes from the movies, and then the characters desperately trying to explain how you reach those moments. It's like watching.
So they're explaining stuff a lot. Through the DVD. Would you say that the game has like more explanation scenes than action?
If you've seen the movies beforehand, it might make a vague amount of sense to you.
All the scenes that I've seen, I never really saw like heavy combat, but it's not like I'm looking for spoilers. I mean, that's another thing too. They're not probably gonna like have footage that showcases like the biggest and best moments of the game simply because it's so plot driven. I mean, I don't know. Yes, until the end, 50-50, really? The game didn't take 13 years to make. Oh, okay. I mean,
but it doesn't work at all within the context of the game. Then you have the Pirates of the
Caribbean. Damn, people are saying it was slow. Like, shit. Now that is fucking cool looking. That looks realistic as hell. I mean,
right?
Oh, I can't tell anymore.
Zondo, he keeps incomprehensible disaster. XG design, thank you.
Combine that with Kingdom
thank
Hearts,
you, man.
Like, what the?
That looks Kingdom incredible, bro. Say, visually speaking, this game looks amazing.
Ever embracing its Disney.
The Pirates of the Caribbean world is on another level of realism.
No charm, just filler bullshit until you finally arrive at the story the developers wanted to tell about anime characters hitting each other.
Isn't that like there's two Rikus?
I'd give this shit.
I mean, it's story. I guess I don't. Wow. A one, my nigga? Is that bad? Bro, I mean, what can I say? I'm probably not going to play too much of Kingdom Hearts, but to see it get shitted on by Donkey like that? I've never played Kingdom Hearts, but I think the character design and voice acting for Sora is pretty fucking bad. Fuck. Do y'all niggas still want this nigga in Smash after this? This game makes me feel like I'm Donald Duck. I do know her. It might be a good spot to find some ingredients. The way he said that shit, like seeing it reflected in this text does not reflect how it actually sounds, bro. This might be a good spot to find some ingredients. That's the way that shit sounded, nigga. Holy shit. All right. Well, that's kind of fucking unfortunate. I'm glad we watched that, man. I have a little bit more perspective when it comes to Kingdom Hearts 3. I guess I gotta respect all the opinions, I suppose. I mean, clearly some of y'all would think that the game is amazing. Hey, I guess that's on y'all. Let's see what else is going on with the real world, man. How have things been? Let's see here. Overweight tiger found in abandoned U.S. home? What the fuck? Niggas got a tiger which weighed 1,000 pounds. Nigga, tigers can weigh a ton. That's easy, bro. Subs on D Amofa YouTube mod. Just subscribe. Etika's really feeling it. Also, just subscribe. The self promo at this point has reached a whole nother level with these niggas in this fucking box. I don't know. I can't fight it. So it's like, fuck it. Just let it happen, nigga. Another donation coming in here from Windy Street Snow or Windy Saint Snow 7 with a $50 donation. Thank you very, very much, Windy. He says, it's been a while, my boy. It's really good to see you again. Same for you, man. Same for everybody in the stream. He says, it's not much. $50 saying it's not much. I mean, That alone, just the fact that the stream has reached that point is fucking crazy. But he says, it's not much, but now that I am employed, I can finally donate after all these years of watching. Much love. And P.S. Can I get the N-word pass? I ain't giving out no more passes officially until I get a system done. I've been doing way too many of these things and not motherfucking keeping account. So people have wound up misusing their N-word privileges. I don't fuck with that. So I'm going to have to reel in a lot of those privileges that I have given out and then actually make a way that I can find out like who's actually deserving of it. But I was thinking of a way to implement it. Maybe we'll do like a quiz or some shit like that. I mean, Kahoot we can't do anymore, but I don't know. Maybe quizzes for the Edward pass. Maybe you can win that shit or something. I want to make one that I can actually have laminated and shit and just send that to motherfuckers or give it to people in person. Imagine that. Like I also give out those pins when people come up to me in the street, but to give out like a fucking laminated card that literally is an N-word to somebody on the street who fucks with me. Now that would truly make somebody's day. I'm gonna catch somebody off guard with that shit. But bruh, how the fuck, man? I'm just looking at this thing right now. I mean, I'm cut a little bit on the board side, man. I didn't want to do anything crazy tonight, bro, but I'm just browsing, man. What have y'all niggas been up to tonight? It's currently 1:41 p.m., so I'm guessing people are going off to sleep soon, but not me, boy. I'm out here. This is my return stream. I want to spend time in here with my nigga, the Broly voice actor. Okay. I remember somebody saying that apparently he was fired. Actor English. Okay, I'm not seeing anything here. Let me look up something real quick. Broly. Not me. I'm woke. Okay, good to hear. The Broly movie was actually good. I'm late. I'm trying to figure out where Broly go to prison. What was it? Let me know in the chat. Broly, was he like fired or something? Mrs. Obama, get down. Classic. Watch the road. When am I gonna come over? From Alex. Hey, listen, man, Alex, once I get things settled off, then I'll be good, man. The accusation, false accusation. Bro, what the hell? Okay, I'm seeing some keywords that are kind of fucking with me right now. What happened with Giggles? Wait a second. Christina Grimmie. Rest in peace to Christina Grimmie, man. I'm just trying to see where this shit is. He got fired over false accusations. Really? This is the guy right here. Mignogna. Is that how I say it? Mignogna. I think I got it. But what the fuck happened? There's some controversy with this nigga? He got fired from being the voice actor. His voice actor addresses false accusations during panel at Back Anime 2019. This is posted 3 days ago, nigga. Fuck. He refused to sign What? Okay, this is already super controversial. You can tell it's late night in this bitch, man. So this is what we doing? He touched little boys. My God, what the fuck? The mob mentality sparked so much movement. What? Rooster Teeth cut all ties with him. Whoa, this shit all just happened. Holy fucking shit. Whoa, this is recent. Mignogna. I mean, I'm not trying to, I guess, stew in the negativity, but I mean, just for like learning sake or like information purposes, what the hell? Stream Supernova on Spotify by Gap. Just subscribed, man. Okay. Here's the thing. You guys who are in the sub box, right? Like, you think it's promotion that you want, but I'm going to warn you, in terms of like what my fucking audience does, I don't know necessarily you want the Joy-Con boys on your shit. It won't necessarily be just a positive, okay? These niggas are crazy, and if your shit ain't up to par, they might shit on you. I don't want negativity being fostered by my niggas, you know what I'm saying? So maybe you might want to watch yourself there, because the only thing that I can see that fucking advertisement going towards is trolling, okay? But help yourself, man. All attention is good attention, apparently, right? But bro, what the hell? All the evidence has been proven fake. Mr. Mignogna, the voice actor for Broly. Bro, Funimation replaces voice actor Vince Ming. I'm just gonna call him Ming for the purpose of moving through this fast. Funimation removes voice actor Vic for anime. Damn, nigga. In addition with, oh yeah, I still got this fucking shit on. Hold on a second, let me move this up. Bro! He worked closely with Funimation through his career, starting with the role of Dragon Ball's Broly in 2003. They replaced him from RWBY, this is Ruby, for sexual harassment and homophobia. Dog! as well as anime fans' claims of his unprofessional behavior at conventions. Rooster Teeth published a blog post to announce that it ended its relationship with the actor. Bro, did my nigga really fuck up? Some people are saying that the claims are fake, though. Bruh, why are people lying in the chat? No evidence has been disproved. I mean, it's the chat. You can't rely on that for solid evidence. I'm just reading up on this right now. Damn. I'm just skimming through. I struggle with the guilt I feel for being so dismissive of his actions. That's fucked up. Damn, bro. I hope to God he didn't do anything. And if he didn't do anything, that it comes to light. If he did do something, then fuck, man. These are heavy fucking claims right here. Yo, my boy Austin just came through with a $50 donation. Once again, man, I appreciate it. I remember back in the day, you were telling me, like, listen, man, I got a hookup if you need a crib, man. Thankfully that we're good now, but thank you. He says, what's going on, man? I'm glad to see that you're back, and you owe me some Ben and Jerry's. Shit, the last time I was at Ben and Jerry's was with you know who, you know what I'm saying? Also, it's funny that you got a new place, but I had a few other places that I had numbers and stuff. NTN, no Twitch niggas, of course. Bro, funny how we just talked about that shit. Yeah, man, I had to make it happen, bro. And thankfully, you know what's also cool? I'll go into more detail about this later on when I'm in, like, a different mode or whatever. But, like, yo, this crib is actually right where I want it to be. I'm downtown Brooklyn, man, back in Brooklyn. When I was living with my moms, I was a little bit out of the city, so... Yeah, it was kind of a commute for me to get anywhere, like, in the places that I normally would travel to. But now that I'm here, it's just like, I can operate out of anywhere, you know what I mean? They photoshopped all the evidence. Bro, I'm not about to go hunting for evidence to fucking see if this shit is actually legit or not. But it's just crazy how they don't give a fuck. But then again, it's not crazy anymore. This isn't unexpected, man. Fucking Me Too movement has taken niggas out. But I think it's rightful, however, because some of these motherfuckers are assholes out here. But if it's wrong, then yeah, that's twisted. And I've advocated for motherfuckers who have had false accusations put against them. You know what I mean? I just hope the information comes to light with this. It's unfortunate that this has to go down in the first place, you know what I mean? Someone said to me, Joker and Smash. I wasn't gone for that long, alright, bro? I still know all the main news. I just, you know, haven't been caught up on, you know, the stuff like within the last month or whatever. But Joker was revealed in Smash in, like, December, right? React to a Attack on Titan Season 3 Part 2 trailer. Now, here's the thing. I already reacted to that, but I don't mind watching it on camera again, just from how epic that shit was. If you guys haven't seen it, Attack on Titan Season 2 now has a Part 2 trailer. So let me throw this one on again, because it showcases some really disturbing stuff. And even though I can jump to conclusions about it, and I know there will probably be niggas that are ready to fucking spoil me all throughout the goddamn chat, I still want to share this experience with y'all, even though it ain't a first-timer, bro. This trailer is crazy. Whoa. Now, once again, bro, just to remind y'all niggas, I have not read the anime. So, you know, this is all literally new info for me as I watch it. I assume read the anime, read the manga. Bruh. I haven't read it. I know. So they go back to the fucking... the hometown, where this nigga Eren was from in the first place. Bro, look at the fucking... Yo, AOT's environments, bro. Considering how much of a fucking head trip this show is, everything, the aesthetics, look at this! Look at that shit! Boy! Yo! What the hell is going to happen, bro? Nigga. Yo, when I first saw that shit, I was jumping off of the walls, bro. That's all I'm going to leave it as. I would speculate, but now's not the time for that. AOT... I still have a little bit of frustration with this show, you know what I'm saying? So I don't want to get excited about it. I'm just going to ride it out and let whatever happens. Even though people said Season 2 was their favorite, to me, Season 3 was the best. Even though they say it was slower, but I feel like it wasn't. And the whole Roderick's thing at the end, my nigga, like, what the fuck? Bro, nobody could have seen that shit coming if you only watched the anime, okay? You manga niggas, y'all can enjoy having your information right away, but I'm going to enjoy seeing everything in fluid, clean animation, okay? I've read that manga a little bit before, and that shit doesn't... It's kind of raw sometimes, man. It's hard to figure out what the fuck is happening. Oh, and speaking of which, man, I figured out my next plan. So considering that this is my return stream and coming back and all that shit, man, I had to figure out some, oh shit, boy, another donation coming through. This one is coming from Nimpo. Nimpo, bro, one more, another one, my boy. That you didn't you donate $50 earlier? Or was it 100? Bro, you donated $50 earlier, man. Like, and you already got a fucking Rickroll off on me, man. I don't need any more bullshit in here. I'm trying to have a chill night with my niggas. Not a fucking night of me being bombarded with bullshit. He's saying, how do you feel about the Metroid Prime 4 development update, man? Let me see here. I just want to pull it up so the stream can see Metroid Prime 4. Give me a second. Development hell? Why is this Metroid Prime 4 development hell a fucking result this soon, right after I fucking type this shit in? Whoa, it's not just Metroid Prime 4 development has been completely restarted. Bro, as a Ridley Nane, I am offended by this. Nimpulse says, how do you feel about the development update? And also, there's rumors of a Nintendo Direct on the 13th. All right, well, let's look into these two then. Just curious. He's saying, so we should get an announcement tomorrow if we do get one. Perfect timing by me to come back then, right? Yo, if there actually is a Nintendo Direct, I don't think I need to re-clarify with you niggas that your boy will definitely be watching, all right? Even though I missed the whole Joker reveal, that's not going to happen again. And there's still four more DLC characters. So before we go on, just to let you know, Direct, yes, is all going down. I'll make videos and shit real soon to explain everything and all that. Primers, we started from the ground up, though. Nigga. Oh, wait, they made a video about it? Yo, once again, Nimpulk, thank you for giving me the heads up, man. You go from giving me a fucking meme to giving me information. Only niggas in this goddamn stream. He's saying, if we get one, Google Nintendo Direct February 2019. If you don't believe me, is a Nintendo Direct really on the way? I mean, are there like reputable leakers that have been talking about this shit? Because if that's the case, then hell, I'm excited. I mean, whether it happens tomorrow or not, I don't really care too much. Although, to be honest with you, when I looked on the Nintendo Switch earlier, and I was trying to see, like, oh, what hot games are coming out for that motherfucker? Nothing really that interesting was on there. I might have talked about this earlier, but bruh, it's kind of not looking too hot for Nintendo in 2019. Do you guys know of any games that are coming out? Hold on. Maybe I'll look that up too. Nintendo upcoming games 2019. Because, like, Smash Brothers was their main thing when they pushed that shit at E3, and like right after, even though I'm not complaining, of course, hold on, I'm not saying I'm mad about only having Smash to play. I've been playing that game every fucking day for like 3 hours, so let's not get it twisted, but I'm just saying, you know, like, although Animal Crossing is a thing, right? But we don't really have a date on that one, do we? Fire Emblem, the new Fire Emblem got delayed too? Bro, these niggas! Although, to be honest with you, I didn't really know too much about the new Fire Emblem game. The three houses? That was it. Bro, I feel like we barely got trailer footage for that shit. Etika, could you stream Smash? Thank you, by the way, to those two subscribers that I came through earlier, too. The Yoshi. Okay, so yeah, is this for the Switch, though? Oh, wait, yeah, it is, isn't it? All right, let's see here. So what else is coming out? Nintendo Switch games. Did you see the oh, yeah, yeah shit? What the fuck? I don't know. I haven't. Wait. Are you actually trying to talk to me? Well, you know, since he said it. What's that? Oh, yeah, yeah. While I juggle a million fucking topics. All right, so I'll open that up in a second. But I was supposed to see what the deal was with this Metroid shit. What happened? This is an official Nintendo video talking about Metroid. Yeah, okay, give me a second, boys. I'm going to run to the bathroom real quick, take a piss. I'll be right back. Give me a sec, man. I've been holding this in for a minute, you know?
Okay, I'm back. Did the heart rate go up or down? Hold on, did I flush? I washed my hands. I don't know if I flushed, though. But, you know, it's fine. I mean, that's one of the conveniences of, I guess, having an apartment. You don't necessarily have to upkeep it all the time. That's one of the things that I kind of, like, forgot in a way, you know? Like, I can, if I have, like, a plate of food, I don't necessarily have to move that plate right away. I don't have to worry. I can keep my crib messy if I want to. I'm just having my own place type thoughts, you know what I mean? Anyways, let's see what the deal is with this fucking video that Nintendo put out about Metroid Prime 4, man. Like, so what's the deal, bro? Like, the development... Just so they did a scale bound to this shit? They did a Microsoft Platinum to this shit, bro? Title change, hello, Etika. Wait, the title change of the stream? Wait, no way. Did it? I wouldn't be surprised if they did something like that, though. Whoa! They did! Wait, who the fuck changed my title? Wait a minute, was this a mod's doing? Etika, you didn't wash your hands, don't lie. Okay, I didn't. I didn't. Hey, listen, it's my home. I don't have to wash my hands. I touch my dick. Fuck it. Hey, listen, I clean my crotch earlier, okay? Fuck out of here. Who cares? Fuck the police, nigga. Okay. Okay, Hey, man, I'm just fucking with y'all, nigga, all right? Hey, listen, it's my crib. Yes, you want to know what? I'm touching your face with it, nigga. Fuck out of here, man. Nah, I ain't watch, man. You probably didn't watch your hands either, motherfucker. I just ran out real quick. Shit, all right. So y'all want me to wash my hands now? All right, fine.
Fine. Since y'all making such a big deal. Fine. There we go. Are you happy? You hear that? You see that? Got the soap suds on there. There. I washed my fucking hands. Now y'all can't say nothing. A nigga is clean now. You feel me? We good. Let me get a towel for this shit. Clean as a whistle.
All right. Y'all niggas probably smell. I mean... No, I smell great, bro. I don't have a funk to me. I smell like dish soap. I smell what kind of soap is that? Yeah, I don't know. But yeah, I smell. Etika, look up Zendo on YouTube, please, bro. Are you're just trying to self promo, man? I mean, there's other stuff that I want to do right now. I don't want to fucking look you up, nigga. Fuck out of here. Somebody told me to look this up though.
Oh yeah, yeah.
KSI, nigga?
Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. I'm in the Litty Committee. Oh yeah.
The Litty
yeah,
Committee.
Yeah, yeah. You're in the Shitty Committee. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. I'm in the Witty Committee.
So I don't get this at this point. KSI seems like he succumbed to this shit, though. Look up Oh Yeah, Yeah, Yeah drama with KSI. Zendo. Okay. Your thoughts on the direct rumor from Blaze. Give me a second, Blaze. Let me, well, I guess I got the point out of this one. I don't know if there was something to salvage there. Another donation coming through. Thank you, man. This one's coming in from, hold on, Grave Paladin, man. I did see your message. I didn't get a chance to respond to you. I know you want that fucking rematch, my boy. Don't you worry. I know Smash Brothers is a requested thing. I know I said I was going to do viewer battles, subscriptions, submissions and shit like that. That'll be later on, though. I just need to get everything set up with the streams regular, and then you'll have your chance to get embarrassed again, Grave. So patience, my boy. He says, what's going on? It's been a while. I hope that Ridley is looking clean for Evo. I went to a couple locals. I didn't do too well, but I mean, I'm trying to hang in there, man. I am going to be the best, really. I told y'all niggas here first, okay? Remember that shit. Real shit, man. Apparently, the title of the stream changed again, so I think it might just be a moderator that's doing that shit instead. You can do that on Twitch, right? I'm not really too super... Watching, really? How scary, bro. I'm clearly shook. All right, let's see what the deal is with this video. I didn't get a chance to watch this shit yet. Man, I'm so chill right now, man. I'm just glad to be back on the motherfucking stream with my niggas, man.
いつも任天堂のゲームをプレイしていただき誠にありがとうございます。
Just look up Zando. He's Rachel's editor. Give me a second, man.
Prime 4についてお伝えしたいことがあります。私たちはメトロイドプライムシリーズファンの皆様が本作に寄せられている高い期待をよく理解しています。
Do they give a reason?
特に一昨年の E3 で初めて本作の発
表を。Dog, you know they felt. How many views did this video get?
ファンの皆様から。
Fail Army? I'll check that out later on tonight. I have a couple more things I need to check out first, and then we'll just look at some random fucking content online or something, like fucking live stream fails or whatever the fuck.
情熱あふれる言葉から実感しております。発表以降、皆様に何ら続報をお伝えできておりませんでしたが、
yeah, no trailers.
その後も開発を継続した結果、大変心苦しいのですが、
Here it comes!
私たちがメトロイドプライムシリーズの基本となる
このタイトルに求める進出には Reach the standards we seek.Are they changing who they're working with for this shit?
Nintendo は常にゲームの品質を追求していますし、開発
段
階ではそのレベルを満たすものかどうかを日々問いかけ。
Yo, we gotta remember that famous Miyamoto quote. I think y'all niggas already know what that shit is. A rushed game is bad forever. But a delay, well, it didn't come out like that. But he basically said, if you rush a game, it's bad. If you delay a game, you could still potentially fix it.Damn, wait a minute. If the development is restarted, then we're not going to see Metroid Prime 4 until 2023 or something like that. How long would development for a fucking AAA game like that take normally? If it's Nintendo we're talking about, it'll probably take a long time. And then the fact that, like, they have to do everything from Jump Street, nigga, fuck. 2021. Did they give us a date, I wonder? I mean, we're only halfway through. If we're not satisfied with the quality.
ファンの皆様の期待に
応えることもできません。
このような観点
から、yeah, what's going on, Ice?
本作の開発の現状は誠に厳しい。
Hope you're having a damn good one today, Blaze.
この度、
I am. Thank you.
開発チームとして難しい決断をしなければならなくなりました。
Shit.
それは本作の開発体制自体を。
Maybe they should have had this problem happen with Star Fox Zero.
具体的には、我々はプロデューサーの田辺とともに。オリジナルのメトロイドプライムシリーズの開発を担当したアメリカのレトロスタジオと、
So they're still using retro, okay.
協力して開発を、
So they're sticking with retro, but what was the problem that happened?
そうすることで、
By collaborating and developing retro.
期待に応えられるものにできると信じています。私たちはこの決断を軽々しく行ったわけではありません。
Wait, had they done it with retro from the beginning, the first time that they went with the... Oh, they weren't making their game originally. Oh, okay, so they hadn't stayed with retro. They were going with a different company, but they didn't like what they had, so they're scrubbing everything. Who was the company that they were working with before, though? All right. For develop... Metroid 4... who was it before, at least? It was Bandai? Oh, that's not necessarily like a bad company for fucking, I don't know. I mean, maybe they just, what kind of choices was it? I mean, they probably don't go into detail like that, but damn, nigga. So 2025, boys, that's when we'll see the next one. I mean, it gives you time to catch up, I guess. Aren't they going to be putting out the fucking collection anyway? So, I mean, I'm definitely going to be playing that shit. Watch the Apex Legends trailer. This is a game that I've heard a lot about over the last few days. And I actually had that one on my list, too. I wanted to check out the trailer and see what the deal was with y'all niggas. It's, like, funny. I don't really do these things on my own. I just sort of save them to the side and check them on the stream. So, yeah, thank you for bringing that one up to the mysterious people that continuously fill up my fucking donation box with these sub messages. I mean, even though they're spending money to do it, I think. Thank you. Wait, the subs are from the Desmond Amofa channel. Oh, so you're subscribing to the YouTube channel through that. I see what you're doing now. Okay, so niggas thankfully aren't spending money. I thought that was the case for the longest, but clearly the system is still a fucking mess. Let's just finish this thing up real quick. Oh, wait, it restarted? Let me fast forward. Re-examine development and change it. We're going back with retro. Okay.
開発を最初からやり直すことに近いことになりますので、当初の社内計画よりも完成が遅れてしまいます。これがメトロイドプライム4の発売を待ち望んでいただいている数多くのファンの皆様を失望させてしまう。
Watch some nukes top 5. Apex is a good game.
皆様には 発売が遅れてしまいますことを心よりお詫び申し上げます。
So Etika's a Twitch nigga now? No, not necessarily. Don't jump to those conclusions. I'm just having my little small return here.
まだまだ先のこととなり。
Whoa, 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 go back, man. I didn't read what you said. How you been, Etika? The Reddit is stupid, lol, from Blaze. Nah, don't say that, man. I mean, I wouldn't say that they're stupid. They're just, you know, they're denied of what they want, man. So anybody would get upset. Let me see here. Thank you for giving me the heads up with that shit. I'm going to actually put this on mute temporarily until I fucking... Now everybody knows and they're going to it. All right, boys. Listen, we have technology for this. Now that I know what the source of the problem is, I might be able to fucking fix it. If I go to my Streamlabs real quick... Aha, you shouldn't have told me your secrets, nigga. I'm gonna go right in and see if I can potentially disable that. I mean, probably not, but... Subscriber alerts. Let me see here. You wait a minute! Nigga, have you been legit, like, going into your YouTube channel, changing the name, and then resubbing every single time to get a different name to pop up whenever you fucking do that shit? If so, props on the persistence. That's respectable, you know what I mean? That not giving up after the first time and even telling me the secret, too. You know, just for that, I might fucking look this nigga up now, bro. He was taking advantage. I like that shit. All right, let's keep looking, man. Let me see. We didn't finish it. Etika, man, become a Twitch nigga. Fuck the YouTube normies. I don't know. Isn't Twitch technically kind of normie in itself, too? I mean, there's no way to get away from it, man. Everything's sort of normie right now. It's a fucking internet, dogs. Mainstream shit is... It's like the wave now. I mean... In 2019, most things online are normie status. We have to acknowledge this, man. Let me go back a little. Restarting development from the beginning. Shit. So completion of the game will be delayed from our initial internal plan.
It's too bad.
But we could potentially get a better product at the end of this. So, I mean, hey, they know what they're doing over there at Nintendo, man. The one thing that Nintendo knows how to do really well that we can all agree on most of the time is make games. Everything else, like providing external features to your hardware or, you know, just implementing simple things like voice chat and a fucking web browser. I mean, that's asking too much. But making good games, I trust them on that. So seeing that they delayed it, there's no fucking problem, man. I think we're good money here. Stream title is once again changing. Really, boys? Jesus, I gotta figure out how niggas are having domain over my shit. I was supposed to look through this thing too to see if there were any new games. Let me see. A Nintendo Direct as well too. Okay, so let's see here. Direct's presentation. We've been hearing whispers of a new one, depending on who you believe. We've had several assurances that yes, a presentation is coming. Rumor mill. Assassin's Creed 3. Assassin's Creed 3 potentially for the Nintendo Switch, dogs? Remastered? Okay, I mean, I fucked with 3 back in the day, man. Connor, I liked him a lot. A lot of people didn't like him as an assassin, but that was like one of my favorite games in the entire fucking series. I'm going to close this. I guess we pretty much got the message here, but just because it's Nintendo, I want to watch the rest. So nothing? No trailer? So what kind of game? Hold on a second. Liam Robertson, man. Liam, I think I have a new job for you, my boy. This is Dr. Cupcakes right here. You know what this nigga does? He goes and somehow finds a bunch of hidden, deep information about maybe canceled titles or changed titles, like maybe like this one, how development's going to a completely different company, or rather like their original company. He covers stuff like that. So it'll be interesting to see if he could ever, in the future at least, dig up anything about the Metroid that existed before they decided to just revert back to retro. I mean, it'd be interesting, I feel. 3 is fucking epic. I still want Ezio. No homo. I mean, no, that's the thing, man. Ezio was fucking loved in Assassin's Creed, so you're not the only one to fucking go Google over that nigga, you know what I mean? Alright. We are... Oh, sorry about that. We are good here. Nintendo Direct rumors. Let's see here. Will we have a Direct soon? So now is a good time. Pokemon for the Switch. I still haven't played that Let's Go Pikachu or Eevee thing, man. It just didn't stick with me. I tried my best, and I mean, I didn't even buy it. I just went to fucking Nintendo World, and I tried to play that shit on my own. And I don't know. How many of you guys played that Pikachu and Eevee shit? Let me see a 1 if you played it, and let me see a 0 if you were like, nah. Because I want to know, am I the only one that sort of didn't even try with that game? Like, I felt bad because I got excited over the Pokemon Go integration. Let's Go is a shit game. But that's the thing, too. Like, fucking Giancarlo Paramengo said that it was a shit game. And as soon as that happened... I just thought, I called it a wrap. It was like, well, there's no reason for me to even bother trying this shit. Delta Season Now, a man came through in the stream with the sweet tart ropes. I see. Wait, no, those aren't the ropes. Those are the hearts, bro. Listen, if you were my Valentine, you gave me this, man, that doesn't fly. You got to get me the ropes. No hearts, just ropes. Okay, wait, hold on. Isn't ropes technically a term for fucking semen and porn? Now that, nigga, just give me the rope. That's a little bit on the sus side. All right, I got to change up my vernacular in a way. Just give me Twizzlers and sweet tart ropes, and that's it. All right, man. All right. I'm going to be watching some stuff on live stream fails. I kind of got put on that by that XQC guy in a way, like the guy who like does those live streams on Twitch and shit, like the IRL shit, man. I don't know, I want to try out new stuff, you know. Like, I feel like this is a golden opportunity for me to just really see what the deal is, man. Some people are going to sleep. Good night, man. Sleep tight, niggas. Why are you on Twitch? Well, why not? I mean, I'm not really hurting anybody, am I? Hold on a second. A donation just came through.
That right there is why you're the best, boss.
The one and only. One of my favorite alerts, man. I got to change all my shit here, too, and update it. Dualibi came through with a $75 donation saying, my boy, I'm glad that I could catch a stream again. I've never been able to donate before, but my ass just came from basic training. So what better way to spend my money than showing you my appreciation? Can I get you to say fuck you to my bro, Matthew Thompson? All right, Dualibi? All right, I got Dualibi? Dualibi? I got you. Matthew Thompson, your boy Dualibi says fuck you. All right, that's coming from me directly and the chat too. If y'all want to jump in on it and say fuck you to this nigga too, y'all can. Thank you very much for your contribution, man. I appreciate you coming back and hitting me with the warm welcome, my boy. I'm out here chilling, man. I ain't doing nothing wild. I'm just browsing Twitter, seeing if there's anything interesting, anything wild going on over here. We're about to change up to another website. Damn. Okay, I saw the fuck yous come through, and Jesus Christ, it's like a damn storm. I thought that was directed at me for a second. Y'all almost hurt my feelings. Oh, it's Valentine's. Y'all should be treating me nice. We should be treating everybody nice, essentially. Dondo, wait a minute. This is the nigga that just came through in my damn donation box. He says, yo, I am Zondo. Sorry for my Discord annoying you. I'm glad you're back. I was really fucking happy. I don't exactly remember when this happened, my boy, so it looks like a fun memory either way, though. I mean, except for the fucking Mario shit. But I mean, hey, I think when I was at this event, I was actually telling people, yo, I don't want to take a picture with anybody wearing Mario merchandise. I don't fuck with that nigga. And of course, I had to give up. This was at the Odyssey launch, though. I remember that much. Reggie was there, too. As a matter of fact, I brushed past that motherfucker. Like, he was walking past me in the store, and I was walking in. And Reggie literally looked at me and then just kept it moving. But like, it was a little, I felt some energy there for a second, all right? I don't know, maybe it's just like me thinking it, but bro, when he looked at me, it was like, wait a second. And then he just kept it moving. He had a lot of people around him though, like staff and shit like that. So of course that nigga wasn't going to fucking engage with me right there in the store, man. Like, that would be fucking next level though. The day that I managed to get a picture with Reggie Fils-Aimé though, my boy, I gotta plan something crazy for it. I feel like any Nintendo event I go to, I have to have a bunch of fucking props in my pocket ready to take that fucking Instagram picture. It will be legendary. And hopefully when that shit goes down, my niggas will bless me with those likes. You know what I'm saying? I got that picture got to get big. You know what I'm saying? And Reggie apparently is a really main too. So, hey, I don't think Inklings or Octolings or whatever should be portrayed in this way, man. People might get mad that you're looting them up. Just DM me the shit instead, you know? Yeah, I love this song. Edgar, this is a Kingdom Hearts 3 summary. Bro, have you seen A Goofy Movie 2? Huh? Huh? I don't get that meme. Edgar, you're banned again? Bro, fuck, man. We've been banned so far 3 times by now. This picture makes sense, though. The Will Smith thing definitely does look like a stand in a way. Is that from the movie? Or no? I feel like that's kind of shopped in a way. Because the original movie one did not look that cool. Edgar, TOS... Wow, do we already break it? Are there any new ways of breaking TOS on Twitch? As a matter of fact, let's take a look at that. Twitch terms of service. Maybe we can get through the stream without breaking a rule. Let's see what those are. Okay, Twitch, use of Twitch by minors and blocked persons, account. Let's see here. Prohibited conduct. Wait, conduct, okay. You agree to not violate laws. All right, clearly. Let's go back here. I want to find something that hits more home. Like, you know, just in general, mannerisms on stream and shit like that. Oh yeah, I didn't get the chat going yet. I just want to see what kind of environment we're going to have to get ourselves accustomed to on here. Termination. Copyright. User content. Okay. Devices, services. Use of Twitch by minors and block persons. Agreement. Okay. I remember them saying that they had something where it was like, okay, if you say a curse word or whatever, then you like, yo, another donation coming through, man. Y'all niggas tonight have been going off. Wait, as a fact, never mind. It hasn't even been y'all niggas technically. Nimpal came through with a $50 donation, man. Thank you. Once again, that's $150 tonight that you did just by yourself, my boy. Clearly, niggas are out here celebrating, bro. But I'm glad I'm able to fucking be here, man. Like, you know, once things really get rolling in the future, bro, trust me, niggas will get to business. He says, we should get Joker for Valentine's Day since he takes hearts. I guess that was kind of clever. He says, if we get the direct on the 13th. Also, the guy who announced the 13th for the direct has some credibility. Really? Nintendo Direct rumor coming February 13th. Okay, so here we go. So who is this guy? King Zell, a user on Reset Era, which has previously leaked many things accurately, posted a cryptic message on the forum saying 13 is your lucky number and I am out. And this is somebody who has done stuff before with leaks and shit? Is what he trying to say that there's going to be a Direct on the 13th? It wouldn't be so far-fetched as it's been 3 months since the last Nintendo Direct, and this would be the first Direct of 2019. Bro! He had a great track record in terms of leaks. He previously got the Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee reveal correct. Wait, I remember that shit. That was actually this dude. And correctly mentioned when the Animal Crossing Switch reveal would happen and told the world when the Nindie Showcase would happen. Alright, so yeah, it's official, nigga. 13! The 13th, bro. You know how I am with this stuff. I'm ready to completely jump off the fucking cliff and yell to the sky that the 13th is going to be it, man. But I'm going to fucking wait. I'm going to give it a little bit of time. I mean, I would want it, but it's like, I don't want to fucking, I don't want to get niggas hyped. You know what I was going to do in January? I was going to make a post on Twitter and be like, yo, the direct is happening tomorrow. Make it seem like I had inside information, but then I would have just been trolling people, especially with me not posting anything. Niggas would have been mad. They would have been like, nigga, you're bullshitting. Fuck out of here, nigga. We'll see in 12 hours. Wait a second. You're right. Today is the 12th. So, okay, tomorrow maybe a direct. Is there an announcement that could potentially happen tonight, bro? Nintendo, I'm going on your Twitter page right now, man. I'm just saying, maybe now's the time to throw on some notifications, you know? But then again, they tweet out a lot of shit, too, so I'm not trying to fucking bit spam with a random post that Nintendo puts out there. Nothing official yet, man, but we'll see. 24-hour stream until the fucking direct happens. It's been a little while. I could do a 24-hour stream right now, technically speaking, but I'm not going to because I want to be rested up. If there is a direct.